DJ, favorite DJ.
It's DJ Alvin, this motherfucker. You already know what it is, y'all. We had to get a crack at that. Stop playing with us. Stop
you
fucking playing with
you
us.
You're the wicked I see tonight.
I am
you
on wicked. Damn, I don't give a fuck.
Woo, we had to warm it up. That is added up Kevo on all platforms. I'm turning on my mic. I can't even say. Anyway, but yeah, that was added up.
You're
sorry.
Loud.
One of us by added up Kevo.
Yes.
Let me calm down. I'm tired. I've been doing all this working out, and then when I do a little something, is what happens.
Cause you need to start working out when they be on the poles and shit.
Oh no.
I guess. No. We lit though.
But anyway, that's
what
my
up?
Song.
We lit.
That is like one of my favorite songs right now. One of Us by Added Up Kevo. That's like, I listen to that like too much.
Really?
It's not too much, but like the beat, the energy of the song that brings. It just basically a song that helps you, like, you want to dance when you hear it. I don't know. How you feel about it?
I like that song.
Yeah, exactly. So I cannot
does it
hear
like as low?
Something maybe. All right, let me get myself together, y'all.
I don't know.
I'm a real human being. I'm out of breath. So what? I'm human. I'm human. I'm tired. I ain't tired, but
that shit was lit.
It was lit as hell.
We got shit to talk about today.
Okay, what's going on? It's Thirsty Thursday. Y'all know how we do it.
Thirsty Thursday, yeah, bitch. Yeah, it's lit today.
It's lit. How's your week been so far?
It's been great. You know what I'm saying? Just been chilling, working. I've actually been working at my regular job. You know what I'm saying? I actually been working this week.
Exactly.
You know what I actually get paid to do?
I know, because I haven't really heard from you. Like, usually me, you be texting back and forth.
Y'all
and
had me
like,
off work for like 2 weeks. My boss was like, do we need to keep tabs on you? Actually, you've been on. You haven't been on. I'm like, oh shit, my bad. Let me move the mouse up in. So yeah.
Oh.
That shit lit.
That's what's up.
Yeah.
It's raining outside right now.
It is raining outside.
Finally, it rains like, what, once or twice a year. So I was happy that I was excited. It's sprinkling. That's not real rain. I'm talking about raining so hard where you can't even see the street.
Really?
And you'll wish your, no, it's not doing that right now. I'm just saying that's real rain to me.
Oh.
What happens down here is a little showers, a little water and sprinkles. But yeah, it's good. We do need some rain. It's raining in California too. Southern California. It's been storming and raining. So yeah, but yeah, I'm happy. It's a good Thursday. Happy Thursday. To everybody that's tuned in right now, man, I'm super excited, y'all. Yeah, I'm cooling down right now. I'm out here dancing with a hoodie on, all black.
You talking about
black on black on black. But yeah, feeling good. Don't yell at me. Feeling good. I'm super excited. What else is going on? So much is happening right now. I feel like I don't have enough time to, like, catch up with my own personal life because I've been super, super busy and just work. I'm happy. My son is on break from school. He started his break, well, officially tomorrow, but yeah. So that's what's happening with me. Y'all hear me? I'm still... Let me catch my breath, huh? Okay, I got it. I'm a G. I got it. But anyway, what's up with you guys? I hope you guys are having an amazing week. We got some good news, man. You know, President Biden signed that 1.9 coronavirus relief, so we about to get these stimmies. You feel me? You know what I'm saying? So if you're behind on some bills or you need to pay some bills, you have a couple bills to pay some bills. You feel me? So, but I think that's a blessing because there are people that
do need the money, and it's just a blessing to have extra. So run me my money. Don't forget to file your taxes. But yeah, run me my money. I'm looking for my direct deposit. I know I'm probably gonna get mine till like next week or whatever. But yeah, everything is everything. What is happening here in Arizona? It's been really quiet. We have some potential battles that I see surfing around Facebook and stuff. You know what I'm saying? Maybe it's gonna be going down. We ain't really had too much drama. We have some good music out. Arizona is steady dropping fire ass music. So if you're not tapped in with the platform, with the artists, please get tapped in and see what's the latest that's been dropped by these artists who are really serious about their craft and everything. They're working hard. So yes, it's a lot of good music that is steady being dropped. One of my favorite albums right now, I believe one of my favorite ones, is going to be by Screws Boy, The Wake Up. Now, that album is super, super amazing. I encourage everybody to go out there and get it. It's on all platforms. I freaking love it. He is a lyricist. Like, he really can rap. He is really talking about something, and you can hear what he's talking about. So, yeah, I'm rocking with it, period. Like, I'm rocking with it. I love it. I think everybody should go listen. If you're truly out here on the AZ hip-hop scene, if you want to support the artists, there's so much good music. There's no reason why their numbers should not be ran up. Stream it. Go get it. The Wake Up by Screws Boy. I'm telling you, thank me later. Go thank him. Hit up his mentions, whatever. It's good. It's good vibes on there for, you know, male, of course, female specifically. Like, it's really good, good vibes on there. So, yeah. I love it. That's my favorite one. That's
I'm back.
Getting to right now.
I don't even know what you're saying. I was exactly. Over here doing technical issues, you know what I'm saying? Making sure sound good. Right. So everybody right. Can hear us right. Right. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
Okay. It's Savage 30. Stop playing with us.
No, I was talking about The Wake Up by Screws Boy. That's super dope. I love it. So yeah, that's what I'm listening to right now. And I'm listening to a lot of stuff.
Screws Boy.
Yes, you know what song that I've been going crazy on?
You know you got me fucked up, right?
What? You know me got me fucked up, right? Oh my, yes, that one right there is super. Oh, I
you
love
know you
that
done fucked, fucked up, now, right?
Yes, and every time I hear that, it brings me back to that scene on Menace to Society when Kane was being interrogated by the detective, and he was like, "So you bought the bottle of beer at 10? He's like, I bought the bottle of beer at 10:03 and I accidentally dropped it. No. So you bought the bottle of beer at 11 o'clock and then you dropped. You know you done fucked up.
You know you fucked up.
He had him stuttering and everything. Like, you gotta stay with the lie. You know, so you gotta stay with the lie. And yeah, but he got fucked. Yeah, I like that song. I think that's super dope. If he had a part in there for the video, I don't know. It is a video offered, but I didn't get a chance to see the whole video. But yeah, that's super dope right now. And another song I've been going crazy on, working out to, is Karate Kids by Cillie Yonte, featuring, help me, I can't think of his name right now.
Cat Pizzy.
Man, that song, it's the beat for me. And I think, especially with me working out and running and stuff, like, I listen to specific songs for the beat, and then it has to be a song that I can rap while I'm, like, working out. But yeah, it's a good song. I really love the beat. I like the song.
Well, let's go back to Screws Boy, because I got a song.
Okay, good. Play. Yeah, let's talk about it. So what song did you, what song was your
song? No, I'm
gonna
play it.
What song you gonna play? The one with
Fucked Up.
Oh yeah.
All right, let's play it.
Let's go ahead and get into it. I like this one. This is the one he performed when he came to do the virtual concerts for the Roku channel.
Yes.
That was the first time I've seen him perform. Like, I've heard about him because you told me about him, but just to see him perform now, I'm like, okay. And then as soon as I heard his album, I'm like, oh, he got those East Coast vibes. He's like, yeah. Oh, he's from the East Coast. I'm like, you can hear that. Like, you can listen to him and you can hear, like, oh yeah, he's from the East Coast. Without even trying to put on an accent, and you could just tell the energy. And you can tell that he really is a rap. Like, he is an artist. Like, he really does this for real. True. Not just woke up, but let me just do this. Like, you can just tell, listen to his music, that he's seasoned, like, he's good. Yes.
Facts.
That New York, them Timberlands, you know what I'm saying, and hoodies and backpacks. Right. Those type of vibes.
All right. We're about to get into it. Screws Boy, Fucked Up. Let me got my damn DJ thing.
After the moment you die, I believe I could fly, but no, not like Kels. Cause the plane he was flying, the pilot probably was 12. I just wanna be me, cause not a soul can do that. I was born to win, and God bless me with rap. I be killing these cats, no animal cruelty. My mind is gold, so I don't need no jewelry. I pray y'all fooling me, right in that tomfoolery. You could've went to Harvard, still it ain't no schooling me. I gotta provide this real rap to your mind. I'm like Kendrick and Nas combined with J. Cole's mind.
That's how it be sometimes.
They
like,
fucked up. They fucked up for real. That's Scrooge Boy though. That was that Scrooge Boy.
I like the beat. I like how he was flying. Everything in that basically, it's just a good vibe song to me. It's a good vibe song. Like I love.
Yeah, it. That's Scrooge Boy though. But wait till we bring. Hey, we got an interview with Scrooge Boy, April 1st. He's coming in the building, and we gonna make that nigga freestyle.
Cause
he has to freestyle. He has no choice but to freestyle. God damn it. Cause he's a freestyle. Scrooge Boy is a for real freestyle. That nigga will go in there and that nigga will freestyle, and that'll be some fire ass shit. Cause that's what Scrooge do.
Yes.
And when when was the first time I fucking heard Scrooge Boy? I don't fucking know. I think he freestyled one time somewhere. I think it was maybe an event. I don't know. But that nigga freestyled, and I was like, that nigga cold. That shit was like years ago. That was like, that nigga cold. Yeah, Scrooge Boy is cold though. That nigga cold for sure.
And he got something to talk about too. And it's not like a whole bunch of violence.
It was lit. We had he performed in the music. My yeah. Event. I was there about, oh no, was I there? I was there when he performed the block. I don't know if it was your birthday event, but yeah. Shout out Val Marie, the manager, the real manager. She on here, she tuned in. Thank you, we appreciate you. Shout out Loud. Shout out, oh, Scrooge Boy, that's what I'm talking about. You tuned in, my nigga. Hey, Verse, you already know. Verse tuned in, that's what I'm talking about. We got one of your artists coming in from New York. Two Tone, the superstar, tuned
Please
in. Please say the superstar. Respectfully, you know what I'm saying? Shout out Xavier. Shout out Torrey, that's what I'm talking about. Tuned in. Demon Noel, tuned in. Buford, that's my nigga. And Askari Shakur. That's not really his name, though, huh?
No.
But yeah.
No, that's not.
That's what's up, though. But thank y'all for tuning in. Make sure y'all share the feed, like the feed, comment on the feed. You know what I'm saying? But yeah, back to what you was talking about. My bad. I just had to share out.
No, that's what's up. Yeah, that's, yeah. And you know what? My other favorite song is Fly Tonight. Like,
so what are we going to do?
We're about to play that too. Yeah, I mean, you can play that one too, like mix it in somewhere, but you have to play that too. I think that deserves.
Fuck it, we'll just play it right now.
Radio play because it's something for women and it's good. And it's like, this is where I'm at with it. Over the weekend, I was just like listening to like just different artists, just like mainstream, whatever. And I'm like, this music is just like some of the music I was listening to. I'm like, it's so violent. Like, oh my goodness, like,
we want some of that love, you know what I'm saying? Some of that real music, though.
So, when you step away, you listen to people like Torrey Masters, you know, mm-hmm. winning awards every day. It kind of like it just basically redirect your frame of thinking and yeah. get you back into a positive note.
Positive
and
energy. Like,
yes, positive energy, something for the ladies, something that make you feel good, because you're not going to always be in a mood to listen to all the violence on the music. It's just crazy. It's like...
Is everybody got a song for different vibes. Like, right. when you in a mood to, you just want to sit there and chill, you know what I'm saying? You put on some Screws Boys, some you know what I'm saying, some Tory Masters. When you want to go and do some trap shit, you know what I'm saying? You got to put on AK, you know what I'm saying? Some Dub Fuego.
Yeah.
What else? When you want to listen to some R&B, who you put on for R&B? J-Rob, you know what I'm saying? You
want to get in
that,
because, yes.
that relationship type vibe, you put on some like, J-Rob, you know what I'm saying?
Yes.
Yeah, like, it's everybody got their own style, you know what I'm saying? And, yeah, like, we listen to everybody at a different point in time. Like,
exactly.
And it is what it is. It, like, it's nothing bad about that. Like,
It's not. Because I put on a whole, like, even I still, like, even with Preem, like, his songs are, like, real hype songs.
Yeah, so, like when you want to get some distance, energy, you want to.
If I'm driving a distance, I'm like, let me put this on. You know what I'm saying? Even Merkham's, because he has that fast. Yep. Like, you know what I'm saying? Let me put this on. Let me get turned up. You know? Facts. So, yeah. But for real, though.
Yeah.
Really got to appreciate the Arizona music out here. Like, I'm impressed. I appreciate it.
Yeah. You know, Arizona hip hop, we can go against anybody on God.
Yes, exactly.
Like, on God, we can.
Toe to toe and stand in. You know what I'm saying?
We can stand our
own. People, if you're not really tapped in, so you may not know, but yeah, that's just what it is. You feel me? Like, yeah. AZ can hold his own, been holding his own, and to the top, to the top we go, to the tippity top, top we go.
They be sleep on AZ, but we gonna blow.
We
and y'all niggas is gonna be like, oh my.
They save the best for last. Facts. You feel me? So save the best for last. Everybody is in a bag though, like music, you know,
yeah.
people, they're still dropping music, you know, so it's not sleep. Can't sleep on it.
Shout out De La Preem, you know what I'm saying? My dog, you know what I'm saying? Skirt. He in the, I don't even know what it is.
Like
it's like a language thing.
A dictionary or something.
Is it the Urban Dictionary?
I think so.
But yeah, he got in there, you know what I'm saying? Skirt. Arizona, yeah. Stop playing with him. Other artist, like he said, but E-40.
E-40, that's uncle right there. You feel me? E-40,
and now, yes. Preem, brother.
He got that language.
And I'm still waiting for my motherfucking name, because Preem was supposed to give me a name in Scarfecto language, but he didn't give it to me, so we still waiting. It's because he can't think of one with DJ Odd. I made it hard for him. It's okay, though, Preem. I got you. I'm gonna give you time, but I'm gonna come back in about 3 days and ask you again. You feel me?
We got songs popping up on TikTok.
Man, we got songs on TikTok. So Trilly Hydro, he got a song. Okay, first Trilly Hydro, this was like 4 days ago, I think, or 3 days ago, maybe on Monday. I think Yante was like, "Hey, Trilly went on TikTok." So one of his songs, Trilly Hydro. I don't know if y'all know Trilly Hydro, but he went viral on TikTok for a song. That shit hit 30,000. Views. 30,000 views for his song on TikTok. Arizona is fucking popping and niggas don't even fucking know. Stop playing with us. Even though he's from Alabama, we know who put him on Arizona. Guy, no, I'm joking. But yeah, Trilly Hydro. Yeah, so he on here and it says Arizona hip hop 30,000 fucking views. Like, do y'all see this shit?
Matter where he from. Like,
y'all, like, look at that shit. Read that shit. It's 30,000 views. I don't even know. Let me see. If y'all
it don't matter that
shit.
He's from Alabama, but he's here. Like Yante say, Indiana, but Arizona made me. You feel me? Like, yeah.
I don't even
so
know if y'all can see that shit.
Nah, what is all close up in the minutes? All blurry. Bag it back some. A lot. Yeah.
Oh, there we go.
Exactly.
30,000. Y'all see how that shit say Arizona hip hop at the bottom? Stop fucking playing with this man. Stop fucking playing with him. That shit say 30,000. That shit tag Arizona hip hop. Y'all niggas better start tagging Arizona hip hop in y'all shit and stop fucking playing. Stop acting like we don't fucking be representing y'all.
Cause Arizona made it.
You feel me? Stop playing. Then we got Network over here. Nigga, shut the fuck up, bitch. Shut the fuck up. What? That's my shit though. I'm about to play that shit right now. But yeah, then we got Network. He over here got Christian Combs dancing. That nigga sea walking in his shit. And that's his wife. It may be his wife that is the one that's on the hook that he's actually dancing to.
Oh, really?
Because it's the female that's actually singing it. Of course, they're all in the song, of course. But right. You know what I'm saying? But it's the female that's singing it. But yeah.
If y'all don't know who Christian Combs is, that's
P. Diddy's son. Puff Daddy, P. Diddy, however the fuck right. You want to call him. You know what I'm saying? Walk and give me some cheesecake. Stop playing with him. But yeah, his son is dancing to Network's fucking song. Like, y'all niggas need to go show support and go share that
shit.
Who
gonna share it? Who actually gonna get on there and, yeah.
And he did that shit. Like, what? Stop playing with him. After y'all niggas was down-talking that nigga the other week, talking about, oh, don't nobody gotta pay you $200 to go do for the kids. You should be paying $200. Nigga, what? all them blessings he did, guess what? That shit done came back tenfold. Stop playing. Now his shit about to go viral.
Because if he posted it, people that's following him looking at him like,
you know how many people's on Christian Cone shit? Stop playing. And that nigga does music.
Right.
Like, I be downloading Christian Cone shit. Like, stop playing with me. Like, that nigga is about to go viral. That's two artists in Arizona in the last fucking week.
But have anybody shared or listened to the song?
These niggas don't want to share that shit because it ain't part of their fucking clique. And these niggas, and you know what I'm saying? But guess who gonna share that shit? The media gonna share that shit.
Yes.
Okay?
Exactly.
Why? Because that's the shit that we need to know about. Stop playing with us. I'm sick of y'all niggas. Stick of y'all niggas. Y'all niggas don't be wanting to share none of the shit that we need to be sharing. Then y'all get mad when we share fuck shit, but all y'all niggas want to talk about the fuck shit. But then when we share the positive shit, we don't see all them posts every day. Why the fuck we don't see posts about Network? Why the fuck we don't see posts about motherfucking Trilly Hydro going fucking viral? Why?
Why?
Exactly. Why?
Why y'all not talking about that? Why y'all not reposting it? Why y'all not pulling up the song or going on TikTok doing a dance to the song? Why y'all not hashtagging it and putting it on Instagram? Because you in Arizona, stop playing. We don't want to hear nothing but y'all talking about. Y'all all fake and phony. Anyway, but we got that the real ones is going to hold it down. The real ones is always going to come through and play the music, and we're going to keep it a band. Because we really rocking with it. We do this shit for real. Like, we really with it. Like, you know, AZ, this is us. This is home. This music, like, this is what we do. I'm talking about countless hours listening to songs, listen to albums, download over and over, pre-orders and all that. Like, stop playing. Y'all already know how we rocking at the Certified Savage Show. Y'all know we going to get it in.
We are. And we're going to play all that good shit.
We're going to play all the good music, the fire stuff, the stuff that all these FMs, all the stuff that should be on the radio now.
Facts.
Like the YK Osiris and
J-Rob
song. Like, facts. At the end of the day, I feel like everybody should be planning. Like, why are you not planning? Why? I don't understand. So you don't have nothing to say about
Arizona. I don't know why people ain't trying to play that, ain't trying to share that J-Rob and YK Osiris.
That's huge. Like,
that's fucking huge.
That's huge.
And let me tell y'all about y'all artists. For one, y'all niggas go, y'all pay for all these big name features, and the niggas that y'all got big name features with, don't even post y'all niggas on their page.
And don't even share it on their
story. Don't even share it on their story. The fuck y'all buying a feature for? That nigga don't even share your shit.
It's pointless. It's a Why? Waste of money.
Why?
Because at the end of the day, if it was up to me, I'm going to pay for the promo.
Right.
Okay, I don't care. I'm paying for the promo. Do the feature, and does it come with a promo package?
Does it come with
too?
You having to share this shit?
Or, exactly.
Because if you ain't sharing it, what the fuck I'm buying it for?
Exactly. That's
you
stupid.
You just buying it, and nobody care that you got fucking whoever on your fucking track.
It doesn't matter.
I don't give a fuck. It's a song good. And if that nigga share it too.
Didn't YK Cyrus share the single YK with him?
YK Cyrus put that shit on his post, and he put that shit on his story multiple times.
Exactly.
Stop playing with J-Rob.
Exactly.
He's a whole goat out here. That's why he's level. That's why he's called levels to this shit. That's why he's called a higher tier than a lot of y'all niggas.
Exactly. Exactly. So y'all get the
niggas
features,
smart.
The big features all y'all want, but you go on that artist page, and there's no promo. There's nothing. It was just like, basically, I just handed somebody something. I just gave it to the needy when they do a feature and don't post it. When they don't promo. When they do no promo to it. Like, so it doesn't even matter. We don't even care. But the ones that is sharing, you guys are not even paying attention to that. Like, you are Arizona hip hop. There's no way for you to live here, be on the scene, and not support your fellow artists. Like, it does not hurt or cost you anything to repost, like, share, or make a comment or say something. Like, if you look at all the mainstream artists, they share. They be like, oh, just go get my partner stuff. He just dropped woo-woo-woo, this fire. They always posting it, like, sharing. When you collab with somebody, you have to constantly promote, share, and put them in people's face. Like, you have to put it in people's face. And I feel like there's so many people here that's on the hip-hop scene, whether you make music, whatever you do. I feel like if we collectively put it and post and share stuff, like, y'all share other stuff that is not focusing on us. Y'all share other stuff that has nothing to do with Arizona hip-hop. But then y'all want to sit here and talk shit on Facebook. Like, I don't understand. Like, it's backwards to me. Like, you're hustling backwards. You want the attention. If we can run up these numbers, download it. Everybody should be downloading everything. Everybody should be posting everything. Reposting and liking and sharing, like, it's simple. I don't understand why is it so hard. Who's at them?
They're supposed to come in. My bad. I'm over here trying to get the freaking video.
Did you
network didn't send it to me on my email?
Oh, he have a whole video to it.
That nigga. Yeah.
Okay. Well, just play the song if you don't have the whole video. But anyway, like we said, we gonna share it. What else is happening here? Let me see. I went over that. Blah blah blah. Who
got
tuned in here? Who's
here? Play right now.
We have, okay, play J-Rob tonight. We always play J-Rob. Okay,
play J-Rob what?
And YK Osiris. I be giving people names.
I can play a song. I have it on my
team. I be messing people names up. So if I ever mess your names up, forgive me now. Just put me on auto forgiveness, okay? Auto forgiveness, because I'll just be messing up.
Me too.
Up.
I'm not even going
to Okay,
lie.
I'm not. It's all love. Like, I don't do that to intentionally, like, disrespect somebody. I'm just, like, super bad with names until I remember. So just put me on auto forgive, and then we're good.
All right. But I need y'all to turn up right now, because we about to play Bitch Shut the Fuck Up, because this is for all y'all haters that was hating on Network about saying, and y'all saying, fuck them kids. This is the network is about to tell y'all niggas to y'all need to shut the fuck up. Because this song is now on TikTok with Christian Combs, Puff Daddy's son. And everybody know Christian Combs. If you know Puff Daddy, like, don't play.
Right, you have all right? To.
But yeah, let's go ahead and get into it. And yeah, make sure y'all share this shit. Let's go. Oh, shit.
This in a long time. Little bitch, yeah, I'm back for my third crime. No ghost rider, just a little wine. And a bottle of Ciroc with the gold sign. LMG diva, motherfucker, I'm a gold mine. Block bleeders in this bitch, yeah, it's crunch time. So you better watch your mouth, cause we saying fuck the middleman and show up at your house like, huh? You was all lip just a week ago. Now we got the red dot aimed at the peephole. Flexing on my team is a no-no. Stump his ass out, blood dripping down his polo. R.I.P. Solo Dolo. We got the whole club bouncing like a Lolo. And this bitch drunk leaning like a bitch, shut the fuck up. What? Bitch, shut the fuck up. What? Hey, hey, hey. Hey, that shit was lit,
yeah,
though.
It was. She gassed it, too. That's what's up. That was my first time ever hearing that song. Sometime it be that way.
Yeah, that shit was lit. I know. That's your first time hearing it because I told Network to send it to me. That nigga didn't send it to me.
Because you told me last week that was one of your favorite songs by him. He was like, I've been listening to his music. Like, this is like one of my favorite songs,
yeah,
by him.
And he never sent it. He don't listen. Oh, I forgot. I had the wrong fucking song on here. My bad. That was definitely LMG. Shut the fuck up. But yeah, what was I going to say? What else do we got to talk about? This battle coming up. We got a battle coming up. The battle is going to be with Marley Park and Phile Iñigo. So yeah.
Felipe. No, just like.
No, Phile.
So who you picking?
See, I know Phile is very lyrical.
Right.
So if he's actually sitting down writing everything to where he's going to come in and say what he's going to say, I know that he's going to come with some shit. I just hope that his punchlines are A1. Because I know he can say some shit. I know he can rap some shit.
Right.
But I just don't know, is his punchlines going to be there? And I know Marley going to bring that energy. You feel okay, me? He going to bring that energy. He going to be doing all the extras. You know what I'm saying? And I know Marley could be, a good battler. I still think he needs more practice. I don't know. This one's going to be a good one. As long as nobody forgets their words, this is going to be a anticipated one that we want to actually see, like, for the city.
Right. Even if they forget their words, I feel like with Marley, he definitely should have took notes from the last battle. Finish your opponent. Like,
yeah.
Don't let up. Like we won a battle. We won something. Like, we... He's a good shit talker. He got t-shirts out and everything and stuff that he's doing right now. Like, he built up the memento, and then it's like, we give us a show. Like, really give us what we're looking for. Like, we know you have it inside of you. Like, we just want to shake you up and just, like, bring it out. Like, give us what we know Marley is capable of. Exactly. So, we'll see. So, we're crossing our fingers, crossing our T's, dotting our I's, and make it do what it do.
Yeah.
This could be huge for
him. This is going to be good. It's going to be probably... we'll tell you the dates on the face-off. So make sure y'all tune in. Next week, we're going to have the face-off with Marley Park and Phile. They're going to come here. We got some surprise guests coming. I'm telling y'all. We're going to have some surprise guests coming because don't nobody know certain people are coming. But DJ Aw.
I don't even know.
Yeah, I didn't even tell KJ.
She never really tells me until like but, the day of.
Actually, I did tell. I did tell us. So, yeah, some of us know, but KJ's going to be paying attention. But, yeah, we're going to have some surprise guests, and it's about to go down.
Don't come for
next
me.
Week.
Don't, I heard that. I don't be paying attention. I do. I look, and then I go back to what I was doing.
But, yeah, make sure y'all stay tuned in. So, right now, actually, we're going to play a song. I don't know what song we want to play. Oh, I know what song we're going to play. We're going to play a song. Then we come back. We're going to have Bro God. From New York.
From New York. All the way from the...
East Coast.
East Coast.
Yeah. It's about East to go Coast. Down.
It's NY, about to go down. NY, baby.
Huh?
I said NY.
I know.
Because that's where saying? I'm from. But, like, but what's the saying?
What's saying?
Like, from when you're from, like, New York, like, what y'all say? Y'all just say, like, oh, you're from New York? Or you from
I don't
know.
I was born there, but I was raised here.
You're from Arizona. Okay. Yeah. So we got
but
that.
They be like, no, nah, that's cold, though. You know, I don't know. I forgot. I got to think of what my aunt be saying. Hold on. Hold on, I'm trying to think what they say. Let me. I need to go to some music. I need to go to some music, and then we'll come back and I'll figure out what they're gonna say. We got to get into the song right now. It's called RNL. You know what I'm saying? It's Real Nigga Love. A video just dropped. You know what I'm saying? I should have played the video, but fuck it. The video just dropped. It's a real big doobie. You know what I'm saying? The video go hard. Stop playing with him. Go search that on YouTube. Make sure y'all go get that. I think it's out on all platforms as well. Yeah. So I'm going to play this song, then we're going to come back, then we're going to have Bro God, then we're going to really talk that New York language, and y'all stop fucking playing with us. But here we go. Let's get it.
That New York language. Okay.
Big doobie, respect the motherfucking underground, you bitch.
Oh, I had to tap into a different type of emotion.
Okay. I'm dead. But yeah, this song, Go. You like this song?
I like that. It's just the end when he be like, what do you say? Something, if you do something to me, I kill you. Like,
I know that when I heard that song, when I heard him say that, I was like, damn, don't kill the bitch though. God damn, big dude. He was like, right. No, I ain't gonna do that.
No, but dang, like, don't do that, because some guys are like that. You ever been in a relationship where you know you try to leave and they be like, oh, I'll kill you?
Yeah.
You know,
but you know, that's just like a,
I don't care.
I don't think some niggas don't do that, but you know, some niggas is like, we all kill you.
No, some will do that.
Some will, but some won't. Some just trying to show, you know what I'm saying?
No, that ain't how you show love. I don't want to hear nothing like that.
That's you. Some other females do like that aggressive shit.
I don't.
Well, we're not talking about you. We're talking about everyone.
Exactly. I got to deal with that. So. But no, I like the song. Every time I listen to it, I just think of, what is his name? He sounds so much like,
You said, what's that nigga? Gorilla Zoe.
He sounds so much like him. Not even like he's intentionally trying to sound like him.
Right.
It's just like he sounds like him. Just like how HD sounds like Jay-Z.
Yeah.
I like it. I got to look at the video. I didn't get a chance to look at the whole video, but I see Bobby Denham's in there doing her thing. I know. You know what I'm saying? Swinging her hair. That's what's up.
Facts. But yeah, look, Tori said I would have went crazy on that real nigga on that R&L beat. Great record. Send me the instrument. This man, how are we gonna send you the instrumental? He said we got terrible New York impersonation.
I don't ever do that. Whoever said we never.
This man versed on the battle. That man was talking about his wife while looking at her in the eye.
That's what I'm saying, for real. He did. But that's how you're supposed to do it. If you watch battle rap, you know it's really aggressive. You have to be super aggressive, and you have to go to your opponent, and whoever's there, you got to attack everybody. Everybody can get it.
So but Versa disagrees with you. He thinks that he did kill him.
I didn't say he didn't kill him. That's not what I said.
Versa said that you is the opposite of you. You said that he didn't finish him. Versa thinks that you did, that he did finish him.
I don't think he did. He could have finished him. He should have finished him more. I don't think he did. Mm. I think when Buford froze up, I think he was like, okay, yeah, I want to know. Like, I would have just attacked him right then and there. Like, he was at his lowest point. Like, he choked. Like, you should have went out and choked him and make sure that he was just done. But that's just me, because I really watch battle rap and they really be going in.
I was like, he done. You know, shit is over.
Yeah, you're like, oh, you on choked. To the next. Look at you. You can't even speak, but you don't. I'm just like, see, that's all right.
Hold up. We have a live.
We have a live guest. You have to scoot in the camera. Come on over here just to...
All right. But you can't go live in our show.
Oh, where's the rule book?
But you can't go live in our show. We already live.
She just told you that. Maybe he didn't understand.
You're supposed to share the live. Our live. Or you can like go and request and like we can request you on there. You gonna do that?
Yeah, let's do that.
Okay.
Turn the mic on. Is it on? I don't think you can hear him.
Go. You gotta send a request to us.
Yeah, send a request to us. You gotta get on the page. That's Instagram. Send the request.
No, you don't. Just go right there.
Yeah, go.
So go live. Oh no, don't go live. Go to Certified Savage Show.
And then, do you see it? So click on it and then
send the request.
Help a brother out. You know?
Or you can just send it, or you can just send it.
All right, come on up, come to the mic. Welcome to the Certified Savage Show. Go ahead and introduce yourself for the people that might not know you, or to our audience.
Yo, what up? All the way over next to KJ.
The mic is not on. Exactly. Exactly. I don't hear. Something ain't right.
Yep.
It's not even that.
There you go. Now we can see you.
I don't think you can hear him either.
We can't hear you? Oh,
my bad. Yeah, exactly.
All right, now we good.
Now you can see.
The problem is that he can't request the joint.
Okay, well, can you just send it to his people and messages? All right, let's go.
Is it?
Yeah, oh, you on.
Yeah, I can hear me.
All right. We in there.
Live on the Certified Savage Show. It's Bro God from up top Rochester, New York, 585. You already know, represent East Coast Connect. You heard Upstate of Mind music. Really, though.
We're going to put that down. So is 585, is that a zip code?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Yep, that's the area code. That's our area code. So if you ever got a 585 number coming across your phone screen, it might be me.
Oh, it ain't going to be coming across my phone
screen. What?
It ain't going to be coming across by.
In general.
I know.
So Rock, area, yeah.
I know. So Rochester, New York. How close is that? What is it? Rock?
Okay. Rochester.
Oh, Rochester.
Rochester.
And you born and raised from there?
Yes.
That's what's up.
No, I was born in Long Island.
Shout out to the island. Shaolin.
Yes. So, what made you come all the way over here?
You just messing up everything.
Oh, my God.
Hold on.
Yeah,
hold on.
Yeah.
You got it? Because he came in tearing up. Done
with y'all.
Dang, you bringing people in here tearing up stuff? Hold on. Look at that.
We ain't trying to cause no static.
We're going to have to make sure that stuff still works because...
I'm about to have a long talk with ID.
How we gonna balance it?
Just leave it like, okay, look. So
I'm trying to my phone job.
Yeah.
Okay. Make it look. You need to go backwards because this is the camera that you're looking at. You're not looking at them.
That one. Yeah. I gotta get proper camera etiquette. Back.
Right, and you don't. Yeah,
I don't got to do nothing.
You don't have to do nothing. Just speak and talk to the mic. I mean, you used to being on camera, right? You're an artist, so I mean, you make videos and you record videos,
yeah,
right?
But it's the camera we use is just a little bigger.
It's a little.
Tone said, "What's going on? Don't get tone.
Please don't get tone started. Please don't get tone started.
Don't get tone screen recording.
Hey, I'm just a guest today.
Yes, you are a guest.
Yeah, he's a guest. Okay, let's start this whole thing over.
Let's start it all over from the beginning to welcome to the Certified Savage Show. Go ahead and introduce yourself to our audience.
Okay, it's me, Bro God, Rochester, New York, 585 representative, and here with East Coast Connect, representing Upstate of Mind Music. Y'all know how we having it, man. The homie Trilogy in here, Certified Savage Show. Let's get it.
That's what I'm talking about. So you say you representing who?
Rochester, Upstate of Mind.
Yeah, is that like
that's
a label or?
Yes,
okay, that's how long you been on the label?
Officially 2 years, but it's been brewing for years.
That's what's like, up.
But now we're up and running.
Okay. And what made you come to to Arizona?
I was invited by you guys.
So, so you literally came here for us?
And
just for
others,
us?
And a few
just
others.
For the Savage Queen?
All the way from LA, baby!
That's what's up, though.
Is this your first time down here?
Second,
okay. Second.
What did you do the first time you came?
The first time we came, definitely went and checked my man, Lil Willie. What was that studio? The Bakery, facts. Great recording space.
Willie,
man.
I think I know Willie. Yeah. Is he light-skinned?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, I know Willie.
Yeah. We did a few things. We... went to to another radio interview. That was it. The HD, the sports.
Oh, with Verse. You talking about with Verse at FBR?
Shout out VA Verse.
Yeah,
definitely put a record in with him. A couple.
They don't even be knowing. I be knowing. It's okay though. I got you. You feel me? Shout out Verse. That's the nigga. You know what I'm saying? That's brother right there. That's what I'm talking about. Cause. Yeah, Verse do the in and out. What is it? In and out of bounds. Out of bounds.
That's what it was. I knew it was about sports. It was just we was talking.
I got you, Verse.
She in the loop.
Okay, yeah. Okay. So yeah. So that's when you first came out here. So you went to SDR. You was on that radio show. Did you have any shows or performances?
Nah, not at that time. No.
Okay. So you were just out here networking. You know what I'm saying? That's what's up.
Out here, it was the Russell Face. Verse versus Verse.
Oh,
the comedy show. Yep, it was an improv comedy.
I missed that one. I forgot why I missed it, but yeah, I did miss
that
one.
Dope.
Oh, you know why I missed it? Because I be damn, the niggas gonna talk about me in the motherfucking audience. That's why I didn't go.
Oh my God, are you serious?
Hell no. I know too many of them up on that stage. They was not about to come over here talking about DJ on nothing. Hell no. That's exactly what I said. Nope, I'm not. They ain't about to use me as bait.
I thought they was gonna get with me too. So
that is an embarrassing moment too.
Yes, that's exactly why I didn't go.
I got talked about before too.
Nope. That's exactly why I didn't go on there. Because that's what they do there. They be doing it like wilding out.
Word. Yes, improv comedy.
Exactly. Yeah, I'm good on that. shit.
Nah, that's fun.
I can't take no type of comedy on me.
You in radio, though.
Yeah, I know. And I be low. I don't be fucking people like that. No. Leave me alone.
You be talking cold cash.
I be talking real cold cash shit, though. I don't be talking that comedy bullshit. That shit don't be funny. That shit be real life.
It don't even matter because just that, just talking cold cash could get you talked about.
So what's that? That's like facts, cold cash.
Cold cash shit. That means you talking cold. Like, that
doesn't
mean
facts.
Not just in facts, but that means you talking like.
Facts.
Yeah.
We'll get greater than
I don't
evidence.
Even know. When I say cold evidence. Cash, that means like you just talking straight shit. Like nigga, fuck you, you stupid ass. Like that type of that's that cold. I'm not saying those specific words, but that's the only way I can explain cold cash.
Shit talking.
You feel me?
Exactly. Yes. Another word for it. Exactly.
But that shit don't be funny though. But it's not funny though. You don't talk cold cash shit? How your Facebook look? Do you be like what you be doing on Facebook? What you do?
I be sharing my music a lot, and I'm still my regular person on there, but more or less it's for the music. But I still engage.
How?
Should I?
Like, do you comment on people's stuff? Like, do you just be like, oh, you see a comment? Do you comment on there like, ah, that's funny?
Nah, I ain't gonna lie, I do be trolling like.
Oh, you a troll?
You a troll?
Shout out to the trolls. Though. The rigs because.
Oh, the
be getting
people.
In the comments on the news joint wild talking about
oh that. You be getting in the viral comments.
Yeah, I be rolling the strike like that type of shit.
Do you ever share your music in them viral comments?
Nah.
Oh, that's when you gotta share it.
Nah.
You never know who's gonna see it. You look, yeah. You in there
I monetized it, but that's what I be on that for.
In Arizona, they get it how they live it. They share their shit in everything. They share their shit with one. If they see one person on the comment, they putting their fucking music in there.
That's what's up.
If I say, hey, so and so is dope, then you get like 10 other artists that'll comment their shit on my fucking thing. See,
you can't get caught in those. When it's like when you talking about the news one, those people in there be crazy. You be in there arguing all day.
Nah,
with those people. Like they are like so disrespectful and just ridiculous.
They just be saying anything just to get underneath your skin.
Man,
like oh, you're black, so that means you're a dark skinned little. Like they be saying like crazy shit. Like
exactly.
You be like what?
Like you guys want to be.
Man, look.
Oh, what happened when the. Oh, yeah, when he told him it's this no nigger zone.
Yes.
Yeah.
That shit. What?
That's, like, normal. Like, I don't feel like.
It's lunchtime.
I wasn't. When I saw that video, I was like, oh, my God, I can't believe this happened. I was like, okay, well, this is Arizona. Yeah. You go to certain places, it's like, yeah, you don't get caught in certain places.
That's crazy.
I'm sure it's like that back where you from, right? You have, like, certain areas you go to, like, in New York where they're just like, no.
Yeah.
No black
but they're
people.
But it's more of acceptance there. Like, here. Niggas is ruthless over here. Niggas is rude. Like, they blatantly just
up
rude
front,
out here.
Yeah, up front.
Like, up there, they kind of, like, accept it because it's too many. It's a lot of different cultures in New York. Like, my aunt moved down here from New York. She lived in New York for forever. She moved down here from Arizona. She said she could not do it. She said they're racist as fuck. Like, it's hard. Like, it's even hard as a black person to move up within a company out here.
True.
No matter how hard you work, it's still hard.
It's predominantly, like, white out here?
Oh, and Mexicans, yeah.
Yeah.
Predominantly racist.
Predominantly racist too.
Sure. Yeah.
Man, they spewing out there. They getting comfortable, man.
Where?
All over. Everywhere. And then with social media, you know, you can see it everywhere.
Yep. True that.
Second, so
you surely
places
can.
You never thought. Oh, they on that type of time.
That is true. So what projects you got coming up?
With me and my boy Blessing the Faith. That's that player setting. We got like 3 videos. That's gonna release definitely this season. I have a solo project with Checkpoint, this is a producer from Toronto, Canada.
That's what's up.
Got one brewing with my boy SoCal. He out of Connecticut. I haven't finished that one, but the 2 before that, those finished. That's a slew of projects that's recorded and getting worked on. I still got others to answer to. And I have a single out right now, Picture Me Rolling, all DSPs. Definitely go check that. Fresh Vision Production on the video.
What is DSP?
Just the digital streaming platform.
Oh, that's different? We be like on all platforms. We be like, is that on all platforms? Digital streaming platforms. That's a different one. Okay.
I'll be saying that too.
It's okay. Come teach us something from the East Coast. That might be what y'all say over there, you know.
That's on all
DSPs. It's on all DSPs. Stop playing with him. Hey, on all digital streaming platforms.
Yeah, yeah, yeah,
okay.
Yeah.
Look at her. Act like she been saying it forever. actually just learned it 2 seconds ago, and all of a sudden, she's the best at it for her. Yeah, for real. I'm going to start using that, too.
I'm gonna be that. Watch, every time somebody comes in, I'm like,
did you put
it
on DSPs?
DSPs?
They're going to be like, what is that?
I should have bought in on that, man.
You should, because I ain't never heard nobody say that before.
For real. That's crazy. Are we so...
I don't know if we late. Maybe that should... Do you hear a lot of people say that?
That's old, though, right?
It's like an industry term.
Oh, he went up on it.
Right, he said industry term.
No, so any profession you gonna be in or whatever, you gotta like look into it and study it. So you
facts,
terminology, all that.
I think we just say on all digital platforms.
Like, it's on all platforms. I'm just getting straight to the point. It's on all platforms.
DSP. Okay?
I'm gonna forget. I be like DCP.
Yeah. Three letters versus.
Yeah, he go verse. Now he gonna come in and try to y'all late.
I mean,
see,
he
definitely a no though. So he a no.
Okay, we're not tapped in with everything. All right, okay. My bad. Sorry. Okay, I'm not gonna read when I leave.
KJ the asshole. No, KJ the asshole.
No, I got no read. People be acting like we don't know stuff. Like, oh, you don't know that. I don't know it. I'm telling you for real. No, this is an example. You know, when you're having a conversation, say you bring up something like, you know, I didn't know that. Like, when I don't know something, I genuinely don't know it. And they be like, you don't know this. How can you? Because I don't know. Yeah. I don't know everything.
But that's when you, it's a learning.
It's a learning.
No, teach me.
I asked y'all with
cash was.
I think I got that from somebody else, though.
We'd be like, you talking big Texas shit. That's what I used to hear. Like, you talking that big Texas
big boy. Boy, shit.
See, anyway, so you're saying you're assigned to a record label, right? Is it or independent?
It's independent. It's,
okay.
Is it yours or someone else's?
And partner, yeah. Yeah, part of it is mine.
Okay. That's what's up. Versus, yeah, you trying to say y'all dumb.
I didn't hear that.
He said, I ain't trying to say y'all dumb. Okay.
Said that in another way. I'm not just playing. I'm just joking. Y'all know I'm just joking.
My bad. Okay. Your name though, how'd you get your name? I did want to know that.
Bro God, that's it's definitely a reinvent, because before Bro God went by Ill Chic.
Ill Chic, that sound like some New
Where
York
you get
stuff.
That from?
That, well, my name's Chic, and Ill,
like in real life.
Yeah, that's okay. My nickname. But the Ill, that
that's another New York term, because you ill.
Ill, yeah.
Okay, go on, my bad.
I'm just thinking about Timberland. That's all.
You know, I was just hopping in. I wanted a name, so Ill Chic. My name got butchered at a couple performances. They called me Ill Chic. I mean, Ill Shriek Shrek. Just hammering that shit. Damn.
Dang.
So I switched it up. But just like subconsciously, I always had the Bro God title, but I never used it as my stage name. But like, I was using it on my social media as soon as I started social media.
Oh.
So like.
But why? Where did Bro God come from?
It came from not to like disrespect or blasphemy with God, but just in an idolization, not calling myself God, but as a God, and then I switched it up from God to G-A-W. Yeah, okay. And then you know, God and dog, that's backwards. You know what I'm saying? You can use both either way, and definitely got love for dogs too.
She don't like dogs, so we can't talk about dogs. So let's move on.
Y'all can talk about dogs. I don't like them, but you can talk about them. That's her name?
She's scared of dogs.
Nah, that's not my name. Nah, but
because it's backwards. D-A-W-G.
Right,
yeah.
Right. The ideology and that.
Oh.
And
that's dope.
Bro, call everybody bro. That's just neighborhood slang. What up, bro?
Okay.
Bro.
That's actually pretty dope, though, like how you did the backwards thing. I didn't ever think about G-A-W-D.
Yeah, no.
I
wouldn't have got that.
I wouldn't have.
I just saw Bro God. I was like, okay.
Bro God.
Like, what does this mean? It has to mean something.
That's what's up. Yeah. I like that. So let's get into your first single. Actually, you tell me which single you want to play. We got Picture Me Rolling and Ill Minded.
Is
Ill Minded old?
It got a date on it. It ain't old. It's...
It debuted on
Trilogy first. Compilation tape. What was that? That was last.
Is it a Trilogy
October.
Production beat?
Absolutely. That was
2018.
Damn.
Is this when your name was Ill?
Yeah, that's when I was.
That's what I was wondering. Yeah, okay, cool. Yep. So let's
that,
play it.
Yeah, that video actually is titled Ill Chic, Ill Minded.
So you dropped it on another project, and
then I put that single, that song on my tier 2 project as Bro God.
Okay.
That was the debut project as Bro God.
Okay.
Let's get into it.
Let's get into it. So this is Ill Minded by Bro God. Back in the day, Ill Sheik stopped playing with him. No, I'm joking. All right, let's get into it.
Your bad.
I gotta get that one.
Bert said, "Why I had no idea that you was Ill Sheik."
Now you know.
If you didn't know, now you know.
Now you know.
And then Mike Terrell, which is like the biggest critic, one of them. This is Fire King. Oh. You got the stamp. How would you feel? How did you feel about the song?
I liked it.
I liked the beat. I loved it. Yeah, I liked
it. Gave you that East Coast feel for sure. It does,
for real. I wanted some Timberlands. You didn't want to. He got on running shoes. You're not a real New Yorker. You got on running shoes. Where's your Timbos at?
March, man.
Oh, it's March? Oh, y'all don't wear them? I thought y'all wore them like all year round.
Niggas do wear that shit. They wear them all year.
We 75 degrees.
I'm from Rochester, yo. I'm not styling on Timbs. I'm not styling on New York culture, but it's a difference. Like, we more of a. We gonna grab what's not really popping and make it pop. We ain't trying to.
That's black people in general,
right?
Yeah. Okay, if Timberland's the shoe of choice, it was a time we straight ACGs. Ain't nobody rocking no Timbs like that. We wearing Nike boots in the summer with shorts.
Nike boots, okay. But, I mean, you know, ACG Nike boots is off of Timberland's low key. The Nike boots, the ones with them like the wide big ones old, right there, and then you got like
and
the
a big long tongue.
Yes.
The Ergo Dome, ACG. I'm about to pull
up. We don't like what.
we in the desert, bro.
Okay, like,
we in the desert.
Yeah, absolutely.
But either way, y'all like, are know. Everyone like, knows that New York like is known for Timbs.
Yes.
Yeah, kind of like Vans just added a fucking Vans just added a little width to the bottom of the shoe, but we know that shit damn near the same. That's what I was trying to say. Okay, that's what I was trying to say.
I'm gonna tell my age right now.
What's your age?
I'm 27, right? So,
oh, you young.
Right. Yeah, that's so of course. So
but we cool. still know that the Tens is freaking
that's
New York.
That's cool, but like where I was.
Now you wear Nikes.
Up, absolutely.
Just like the Dickie suit go, the Dickie, which you recognize, it goes with Timberlands. That's what I see them rock.
Not all the time, KJ.
I don't know what they were. I just gotta let it.
It's a differential thing with it. It's just like when you go to California, South Central, and the Bay. You see what I'm saying? Like it's Cali overall. We gonna ride, but we still where we at and they at where they at.
You know, so, you gotta go to Long Island. You know what I'm saying? Where they wear that real New York stuff. You know what I'm saying? The little baggy. You know what I'm saying?
That.
The New York hat. You know what I'm saying?
We ain't tripping on
Yankees, Timbs.
Yeah.
We got Red Stop Wings playing with gear. Us.
We don't care about no goddamn Red Wings.
Wait, first of all, Red Wings do go hard, and that's where you put the bread at. Red Wings are not no cheap boot.
That's fine, but
those boots are, and they do go hard. They are fly with some jeans and a nice little shirt.
I'm talking about the coats.
What? I'm just joking with y'all.
We got a baseball team.
Oh yeah, the Reds. Okay, yeah.
So
nobody cares about the Red Wings. I was right at the beginning.
Yankees. You're not about to style.
Yankees.
You're not about to style on the wings.
Yankees.
Like
I've never heard of
it. You're wearing
a
Yankees hat, Trilogy. Stop.
Is that a real?
You're wearing a Yankees hat.
Triple A, they the little niggas,
man. Come on,
more than that, bro.
We
got Buffalo Bills.
Listen,
man.
Buffalo Bills.
I'm talking about where we from, bro.
Knicks.
Flower City.
Okay.
Yeah. Nets. Brooklyn Nets.
Yonkers, what is that?
Flower City.
Y'all, yeah, we in Yonkers.
Yonkers. I remember this is a funny one. My brother, when that stuff was like big. Dude, you used to really want to be from New York. That was in Cali, though. They used to like try to talk like New Yorkers, and you know what I'm saying, where the hats and
of course they did, because New York got that good accent. You know what I'm saying? The niggas up there, I'm just saying. Yeah. But yeah, we gonna keep going on you. We gonna stop fucking with you. We gonna represent for Rochester.
Rochester.
You know what I'm saying? Today, that's what we gonna do for you.
Are there any big artists from Rochester?
Absolutely.
Who?
Me?
No. You said him.
Well, yeah, like mainstream, like, nah, like we would know.
We had a lot of main, like a lot of people have shuffled through Rochester before getting to the mainstream stage.
Okay.
It's a lot of history before me, like. Triller probably could tell you his timing up there, like with the whole Bad Boy thing.
Okay.
Missy was low key through there. Timberland was through there.
Through? Are they from?
Right. No, we said from.
Yeah.
Okay. For us, we got Tweet.
Tweet. Okay. Okay. I like Tweet.
What's that song from Tweet?
Stevie J.
Stevie J from Rochester. Fact. Oh, he a go out here. Stop playing.
Man. Yeah, like, you know, just rich history.
Well, if you from New York, niggas don't be like, oh, I'm from Rochester.
Nah, well, that's like
Arizona.
That
niggas don't be like,
that
I'm from Chandler.
That shit about to change, you heard. That
no,
shit ain't happening
no
more.
It gets like that because when you think about it like this.
We can't hear you. Get on
the
mic. We
can't hear you.
When I was back in the day, like I was from upstate. I go down to New York. Norfolk is new. I wasn't from New York City. Like, they knew that.
See what I'm saying?
Why did they know that?
Because I had a different whole different accent
what,
than them.
You see what I'm saying?
I had a whole right different now. Accent.
It's a whole hub right now. Like, how y'all gonna do it? Like, how y'all put, like, the whole Arizona? Like, y'all just don't put, like, yo, y'all put, like, the Phoenix. Okay,
Scottsdale.
It's a whole hub upstate NY. Like, it's Rochester. It's Buffalo. So, it's like, people go through, like, you know, the West Side Guns and all that stuff. They go in Conway. It's a connection somewhere, a connection with other people there. And Benny the Butcher is a connection in Rochester, too, that put it right there. So it's a hub upstate NY.
Shout out Greenlander, too.
There's people that's in Greenland. Greenlander got a connection with 38 Special. So it's like,
Special.
It's a connection that's coming up. It's coming from Rochester, too, that somebody going to get out of there. And then same thing, you got Syracuse, got Tootsie. So everybody know Tootsie.
Facts.
Y'all know about Tootsie?
Yes.
So it's just a hub up there right now. So it's just a whole thing.
That's the thing. Like, back in the day, like, it's different. Like, the transition, I think, happened with these niggas where it was like, yo, fucked up. Like, it was one of those things where it was like, it was an identity crisis where it's like, yo, I ain't from Brooklyn. I ain't from Queens. Like, when you say, yo, where you from in New York, like, they instantly say Brooklyn or you from Queens.
Yeah, they shot
something like that.
I'm from
Syracuse or something like that. Like, there's other places.
It was like, niggas, there's farms up there. Like, they be...
Yeah. But you go through them neighborhoods if you want to. You go through them neighborhoods if you like.
Nah, you...
I'm telling you, it's just...
It be different,
man. You know, it's different now. And
upstate is, again, like, it's the respect right now that, like I said, it's a hub. And that's why, like, it's somewhat like how Arizona is, because Arizona has grown. Like, I've been peeping Arizona for a lot of the music scene. It's grown crazy. And this is becoming like a hub. That's why we bringing this connection that it's East Coast Connect. People to come here to know that, yo, Arizona popping. Right. You're kind of upstate. Right. Yo, it's popping. It's popping upstate right now. Music. Just keep on this connection right there. Growing this hub up and making everybody break out of their location.
Facts.
Facts.
That's dope. So, what do you think about are you familiar with the scene out here, the hip hop scene, or just a little bit?
Not as much as I should be and want to be. But I did check out a few artists when I was at this strip club.
Who? Name the artist.
I don't know the music. It was strip club music.
What strip club?
V Live.
Recently?
This was like this was the first time I was out here.
Oh.
And they was playing like some couple local joints, cause my man was the DJ. And
who's your man's?
KJ. He don't even live here no more. He moved out from out here. But yeah, he took me cause he was spending at V Live one night.
That's what's up. They spending local music at V Live cause they surely barely spend local music anywhere.
He got to choose, you know what I'm saying, what he wanted to play. So he put him in his little place.
That's what's up. How's the scene out there where you are? The local
it's
scene.
It's bubbling. It's lovely right now. I love every second of this shit.
Do y'all niggas be on Facebook, like, getting into, like, crazy shit? Like, y'all
They got all that.
So they be, like, talking shit on Facebook,
man,
and everything.
I just seen a stat today. Who the best videographer in the town?
Okay, so it's not just Arizona.
Yeah, I be seeing all
damn
that shit.
Damn.
If you look at my Facebook, I follow Arizona hip hop. Like, I got my peoples that I like out here and stuff. If you look at my Facebook, I got like all upstate Arizona. Like my Facebook timeline, it'd be crazy. That's why.
You be mixing people up, like, oh shit, he talking about Arizona.
Like, I know what's going on with the battle rap, and to me, honestly, I ain't really like the battle rap. Keep it real. I ain't like the battle rap, man. I felt like, man.
You didn't like that specific one.
That battle rap that y'all just did.
But you know why we had it though, right?
Why y'all had it?
Because some niggas was arguing.
That's the whole point, though. If you are, that's
the
whole point.
But we didn't expect for it to be that big. We thought it was gonna be some local shit.
That's the whole point. I'm the outside looking in. I'm a fan of Arizona hip hop. If I'm looking at it, I'm thinking, and battle rap is crazy where we at.
So it wasn't authentic.
It wasn't like no. It felt like I'm not like Marley was dope. It felt like no preparation for it. Like I looked at it like, yo, they really look like y'all could have did this outside or some joint, like on some joint. But I definitely like the hype up for it.
So we did our job.
Yeah, y'all did your job.
Yeah, we can't tell.
Y'all did a great job. That's the whole point. Cause I was like, oh shit, I gotta look at this. I gotta look at this battle. Then when I seen, I was like, oh, he choking, damn. And when I look at when you choke, that's a bad look.
Exactly.
Like, I look at it like,
exactly. If you're a real fan of battle rap.
So that's what I said. Yeah. So I'm looking forward for the next one.
See? He already ready for the next one.
Can I give my one critique about that? I feel like Arizona is focused on, like, a lot of the artists specifically are focused on the other artists. Like, I feel like if a lot of these artists just kind of focused on them, and kind of just did their thing, because there's a lot of dope fucking music out here.
It is. That's fact.
Deadass. Like, there's a lot of artists that I fuck with out here. And I just wish sometimes, like, the little squabbles would get kind of pushed to the side. You focus on your shit and then just let your music speak for itself. There's a lot of motherfuckers wanting to listen. There's gotta be a lot of these
niggas' music can't speak.
Everybody talking about haters. You know what I'm saying?
I'm serious.
Deadass. Like, just put your music out because people are listening to it. And the more we put out, and the less we shut the fuck up. I think that.
But we still need, you know what I'm saying? We still need some shit to be popping. You feel me? Like, we can't just be sitting out here just putting up music and we don't have no scene. You know what I'm saying? We gotta be able to, you know what I'm saying, talk stuff, put some drama out there a couple times.
And the drama comes in on some real shit.
Fact.
Like, if we talking about, like, it, boom, you say, like, a Corey S and a Torre Masters put out projects at the same time, around the same time, and the buzz is about them two niggas.
Yeah.
And the next thing, 2 months from now, is, you know, Desert Baby and, you know, whoever the fuck. I don't know who y'all got problems with. I'm in the outside space.
But yeah, no, we got you.
So it doesn't even matter who it is. And it's just one of those things where you judging that music off of that music, and that makes that artist want to work harder because damn, they saying that this album is better. And it's not firing off like it's criticism or hate, but it's actually received as criticism. And then the people that are giving the criticism are actually giving criticism, just not talking shit.
Got you.
Respect.
Okay, so I have a question for you. And no one else in this room is allowed to say anything unless it's KJ. Okay, so if I ask you to perform, is there a fee? It's okay if it is. It's not anything wrong.
It just on a setup concert or just like on the spot?
Yeah, like a concert, like something.
Oh yes.
It's a fee.
Yes.
Okay. Now, what if we said, now it's for the community, it's for the kids, and we're trying to give back? Is there still a fee?
Nah.
Thank you. Good night. Have a great night. We are the Nama Sugar. But yeah, exactly. But why though? Why is there no fee?
Why? Well, that changed the game. We said children involved, and then all across the board, I'm still gonna potentially come across some type of revenue.
Exactly.
Exactly.
That's not even as a grant. Yeah, exactly. And that's exactly what it is. And a lot of people, you know what I'm saying, because we had a whole issue out here in Arizona, you know what I'm saying, where someone was asked to perform, and he said it's a fee for him to perform. And then someone was like, you know what I'm saying, but it's for the kids, we're giving back, it's a community, you know what I'm saying, you could still bring your stuff out here, you know what I'm saying, sell if you want, do whatever you gotta do, whatever. But it's for the kids, and he stood on his $200. So we was like,
artist had a name with himself
in Arizona. In Arizona, like within our little community, you know. Honest, I'm just being honest. It's within our little thing.
All right, so let's look at it like this: what do this artist travel with their own equipment? Like, how do they don't have their own setup? They're not bringing a DJ, a band, nothing.
No. Themselves and the music gets sent to the DJ.
Oh, so nothing is.
We just need his body in there with his.
And he's still doing it with a track, not even.
I don't. You know. Track. You mean like? Is it like
with a song playing behind him?
Oh. Now that's a big issue we have out here in Arizona. A lot of people have to. You know what I'm saying? They don't cut out their main vocals.
Yeah, sometimes. Vocals.
They don't though. I don't know if Bills cuts out his main vocals.
Do you perform with your vocals?
No, not anymore.
That's good.
As of the last, we've been rocking shows with East Coast Connect for like the last 2 years. I say, by my fourth, fifth show with him, I'm like, yeah.
That's what's up. Because that's another issue that we have in Arizona. Everybody wants to perform in front with their vocals in the background. And then some of these niggas don't even.
With it and scream with it.
And then on top of that, niggas just be, you know what I'm saying? They be performing ad-libs. We like, bruh, we know, we already know the song. We want you to perform the song.
Everybody be just screaming this independency stuff, but I remember coming up just hearing about within the industry how these labels and stuff was having artist development. You know what I'm saying?
And that's like what we lack out artists. Here as well.
It ain't around no more like that because the independent way.
There's some people that have it, though.
Exactly.
Why, bro?
What? About what? Artist development? I'm saying, man, just in general, man.
In general, yeah,
like, it ain't accessible for everybody.
He's like,
take your contract, luxury, man.
He's like, you're a lug, bro.
I think that is something that we lack out here is artist development, like developing artists. But then again, like, we low-key, we do be developing artists. They just don't be listening to us because we don't tell these niggas, like, why are you going to perform at a bar of 30 people and still be performing with your vocals in the background? Like, this is not even a real, you know what I'm saying, a real event. Like, stop playing with me. Like, that's the time that you should be using that time to be practicing with no main vocals. Because it's a little bar. And I'm not trying to say, like, oh, you perform at a bar, oh, you not like that. Like, no. Like, even a big-time person can come on there and perform at a bar, but he still need to practice with no main vocals because that's the time to do it. Like, why would you take a time when you're going to be on a big-ass stage in front of all these motherfucking people to start doing no main vocals? That's not the time. The time to do that is when you're at the little places, the little venues, the little, you know what I'm saying, the little events. That's what you got to do. But they still be performing with vocals. Like, it's not that serious. Like, I don't know. If I was an artist, I'd be on a whole other type of level.
Well, let's start your artist development. I'm going to be your manager, and we're going to go ahead and get you ready. We're going to get you out there.
What are you going to be doing? Are you going to be doing a performance out here, though?
Yes, I am. With tomorrow.
What kind of performance?
A virtual performance with Partake.
Ooh, so Partake, that's what Chief and Verse.
Facts.
That's what's up. And when do you think it's going to be out?
I have no idea.
We don't ever know a person I'm going to put it out. They just be all of a sudden, boom, there we go.
I'm glad they got me on it, so thank you.
I'm interested to see how you perform. And you be with no main vocals, that's going to be dope.
Thank you.
But let's get into your next track, because we over here running short. Okay, let's get into your next track. And this is the Picture Me Rolling.
Yeah, video coming real soon. Fresh Vision Productions, holla. All right,
let's
on all platforms.
No. DSP. Damn it. All right, let's get it.
All platforms. That's how we do it. Put the explanation.
Yo, we is back. We are back.
That's my cousin for real. This is my blood cousin.
Listen, this all is I the know,
again, I do.
Verse, this is your boy. You feel me?
Like, he just
keeps messing up our freaking cameras, yo.
Look, you cannot Verse. Touch anything. Don't touch anything for the rest of the time.
Hold up. Verse just gave us a challenge. He said, Ah and KJ, we need y'all to battle on Bar Wars, KJ versus DJ Ah, whatever
Let's
artist
get
y'all
it.
Want.
Let's get it.
Like local, like Arizona artists. I would kill KJ.
First of all, wait a minute.
Shout out to Bar Wars.
Girl, let me tell you something. My music, girl, please. My catalog, what I listen to.
I gave her the catalog.
AZ catalog, but I know local everywhere. I do local.
Wait, are we doing AZ or are we doing AZ?
Trilla kicked out.
A cash prize for y'all. Would it be worth to y'all?
I want to go.
Really
I want
chipping like that.
So
but...
just a mainstream or just Arizona?
I mean,
because
I can do
first.
Local.
As
Let's
first,
do local. I can do local, just not from Arizona though.
I like the local.
I'm tapped in with local from Long Beach
oh,
to
okay.
everywhere.
Hold up,
like,
hold up,
I'm tapped
hold up,
in. You
hold
know.
Up, hold up. So we could do a verse. We could do a Battle Wars, and it could be KJ with her California shit. But I'm going to bring that Arizona shit.
No, they go hard.
Shit.
They go hard. Don't play with me.
You can go hard, man. But Arizona going to go hard dirt because I'm going to bring every fucking banger I know. KJ going to be like, damn, that's a good one.
I'm going to be like, yeah, then I'm going to hear about this to match that. Oh, yeah.
Not
yeah,
local. Not local.
Yes, it is local.
Okay, let's go.
But some Burst, got these big deals. My local nigga, they got big deals now, though.
Set that shit up. We might have to go live with this one because, you know, I'm coming out with every banger. Arizona. You know,
I get to play Arizona, too.
It's about to go down. Burst had to set a whole new thing up. Okay, my bad.
Yeah, y'all back.
So you got to give your last shout out because we got another interview. Oh, my God. That's crazy.
You want to give a shout out? Give a shout out first, bro.
Yeah, shout out upstate New York, man. Keep working this shit, man. Shout out East Coast Connect. Shout out Chilla G. Danny Splash over there in the cut, man. Putting it all together. Definitely shout out Certified Savage Show. Thank you for having me.
Thank you for coming. So you're doing a virtual performance tomorrow, right?
For Partake.
Okay. Tomorrow. Oh yeah. All social media, Bro God. Twitter @RealBroGod. Facebook, Chic Bro God. Instagram, Bro God. Tap in with me too for feature inquiries, man. Got a lovely price. Definitely will work with you, man. Just be about your business on your craft, man. You can work something.
I just want to say, you know, this is the dopest show to me. You know, Certified Savage out here, man.
Great
you know,
energy,
it's definitely great energy. Y'all ladies doing y'all thing. Definitely thank you for having us. Yo, shout out to VA Verse, too, man. VA Verse, that's my bro right there, man. I be thinking he the dopest, man. He is the dopest.
Yes.
Shout out to Hip Hop Anonymous. Guap Nation. Right, definitely. So, you know.
Y'all talking about
you
like
stay
the
in
music?
NY, right?
Huh? As an artist. He letting a lot of brothers breathe right now.
Oh, yeah.
He got something coming, too. Shout out to VA Verse, man.
You stay in New York, right?
Yeah.
You live there? Okay, yeah. Well, thank you for tuning in to AZ Hip Hop and staying with that. That's what's up.
Yeah, that's dope.
Yeah, anybody that come through Arizona, definitely come through Certified Savage Show. Certified Savage Show. They put that stamp.
You know what I mean? Hey, but Verse, yeah, shout out Verse. That's our brother. Verse does everything for us if y'all ain't know yet. Verse does it all. Like, without Verse, we would not have, like, we would just be on stuck mode looking crazy like everybody. I'm not going to say it on the show, but.
But no,
you know
he comes through crunch time because, man, you have to always say thank you, Verse, because I'd be like, oh my God, go to Verse. Like, I got to ask Verse. Oh my goodness.
I'm like, we got an idea, go to Verse.
For everything.
Like, I swear, like, we gotta go
he do
to
personal stuff, like, you got it. Business, logos, that. Everything, bro, like, he'll come through for you, like, he gonna bring your vision to life, and that's real, like, whatever you tell him you want, he'll bring it to life.
I'm gonna say this, that's my bro right there, because VA Verse, yo, I'm away on the East Coast, and me and Verse, we put so much things together, he did my logo, we put so many things, we only been in the same room probably, like, three times.
Us two?
Like only in the same room.
Actually, no, probably like a little bit more, but
like,
yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like, we not in the same state, none of that. So yep. It's like our connection, and what you said, like, I'll be the same one. Like, yo, I gotta go holler at Verse. Hell, Verse. Yeah.
Yes.
So it's always thank you, Verse. Verse, you my God.
I love
facts.
I love my little bro out here handling this.
And I got the Verse from Verse, too.
You got a Verse
from
Verse?
From
oh, shit. You got a Verse from Verse.
I'm telling you, Verse is letting people breathe right now.
Oh, shit. Well, we about to go ahead and get into some music. After we get into some music, we're going to go ahead and come back. We got Vonnie G coming up, and it's about to go down. Thank you a lot, Bro God, for coming in. We
thank
appreciate
you.
We're going to take some pictures, you know what I'm saying, and we're going to come back.
All right,
so right now I'm going to go ahead and get into this Dorrance Man fight. He just sent me a track. It's called Racks on Racks. Racks on Racks on Racks. Oh, wait, hold up.
Hold on.
Stop the music. Hold up. I don't know what, because I had to put this on there to make sure I didn't forget. But Kane said, if it's only AZ locals, you be in trouble. I need you to tell me a little bit more when we talk about our verses. What do you mean we gonna be in trouble? Like, I'm gonna be in trouble because we don't have enough good music? Or is KJ gonna get in trouble because we got too much good music? So I need you to come back, Kane, and tell me what you
so
was talking about.
So when we do a verses, I should be able to play, like, how they go back and forth. Like, yes, I know AZ local hip-hop, but I feel like if we do local, like, there's other states that have local artists.
No, but if you're doing AZ local, you said you're doing California
No,
local.
You said I was doing California.
Yes,
you said
that. She was like, I got Compton.
No,
local.
No. I said that there's other artists that go, I follow all the locals, like, in other states, too, just not in AZ. Like, it's stupid. Yeah, like, it's fire. Like,
oh, well, then do whatever. I'm just going to play all Arizona locals. And I guarantee I'm going to win.
Okay.
I think
That's a good challenge. I can really win off Arizona. I know too many bangers from Arizona. Yeah. I know bangers niggas don't even know about. Bangers on bangers. But yeah, so let's go back. We're going to go back to this song. I forget what song I was about to play. What song was I about to play?
You just said Manfly.
Oh, yeah.
Thank me. You need to thank me because you forgot. All
right, we're about to play Manfly Racks on Racks. It's a new song he sent today. So let's get it.
I got racks on racks. I got racks on racks. X, X.
My bad.
I got racks on racks. I got racks on racks. I got racks on racks. Cause I got a bag. Now they mad. Hat off my ass. Gonna be stuck in last. Now I'm up on the last. Home lane. I be coasting. Fuck what I did and told you. Doing exactly what I told you. I ain't even trying to hold you. Now I got racks on racks. Cause I got a bag. Now they mad. Hat off my ass. Gonna be stuck in last. Now I'm up on the last. Home lane. I be coasting. What I ate it and told you, doing exactly what I told you. Main flying, tryna hold you. Yeah, I've been back for a minute now. Pop up and shut the whole city down. Man, fly back around. Better hide your bitch now. Pressing everything moving. Gang here, let's shoot a movie. Marley and this bitch stewing. Whole team been booming. Been fly, that's me. Yeah, I charge not to speak. They must have thought it was sweet. Like it was gonna always be free. I've been doing this shit a lot lately. No, I can't lose. And half of these niggas ain't even been racing. Whole lot of money stepping. I done hiked a couple levels. Flagpoles say good fellas. We 12 to be stressing. Everything else extras. All that waiting took patience. We 12 to be stressing. We 12 to be stressing. Now I got racks on racks cause I got a bag. Now they mad. Hat off my ass, gonna be stuck in last. Now I'm up on the laps. Home lane, I be coasting. Fuck what I ate it and told you. Doing exactly what I told you. I ain't even tryna hold you. Now I got racks on racks cause I got a bag. Now they mad. Hat off my ass, gonna be stuck in last. Now I'm up on the laps. Home lane, I be coasting. Fuck what I ate it and told you. Doing exactly what I told you. I ain't even tryna hold you. Now I got racks on racks. Major moves, I'm on the board. My team, we up on the score. Now them hoes at the door. She come in, she gotta go up. If not leave, so what? We still gonna be fucking them up.
Main flight turn me up. Bass drop, make that ass drop. New pounds got me winning. And I told niggas quit playing with them. I think they thought I was finished. Fuck them, they thought I wasn't with it. Like I wasn't gonna ball on these niggas. Back in the game. I'm straight to the hole on these niggas. Hole in my bag, my hand gone. No, I ain't got it, leave me alone. Really, I do what you need alone. Come and get it before I'm gone. Me and my niggas, we bout to be on. And all these off niggas mad. Got off my ass, I got me a bag. That's what got them in lags. Now I got racks on racks, cause I got a bag. Now they mad. Head off my ass, gonna be stuck in last. Now I'm up on the last. Home lane, I be coasting. Fuck what I ate it and told you. Doing exactly what I told you. I ain't even tryna hold you. Now I got racks on racks, cause I got a bag, now they mad. Hat off my ass, can be stuck in last. Now I'm up on the laps. Home lane, I'll be coasting. Fuck what I ate it and told you. Doing exactly what I told you. I ain't even tryna hold you.
And we back. Oh, I know how we could do the freestyle now.
How?
So now they can hear it outside of the thing. As long as I turn this off and I put this on, and I think I can play the music. Let me see. Hold up. Hey, yeah, we're figuring this shit out right now. Nope, I lied.
No.
Okay.
Try again next time.
I tried. for the next time. So what's up? What's up? Who we got in the motherfucking building? G is in the building. Vonnie G's in the building. Where's your fan base? Not your fan base, but your group. Now. Oh, my bad.
Damn. Well, they all live in different parts of the city. I ain't going to pick them up. I got gas.
But you came here for what you call it? The fuck? Right.
I drove here, though.
But you just got your stimmy. You didn't get your stimmy check?
I'll get that next week.
No, we get that next week. Yeah, for sure. Right.
Yeah, I pick it up. Stimmy. No, gas is high, though. I ain't going to lie. Gas is.
Where the fuck did Denzel stay?
Denzel stay out by me on the west side.
So why the fuck ain't he here? He was here for KT Gibson interviews.
Kids. He got his kids. He got three kids, yo. Hey, I ain't got no kids. I do what I do. I move freely.
Oh, okay. You know what I'm saying? Well, I got kids, so I don't move freely.
Kids. Yeah, I don't either. I got to schedule stuff. Like, what time? Okay.
I mean, that's how he is. He got to schedule it. So if it ain't around his schedule, it don't matter to me. I just move freely. I don't need him. I love him, but
I got kids. I can't move freely, unfortunately. But you know what? I still get shit done.
Yeah. True.
At the end of the day. That shit get done. So how you doing?
I'm good, man. Living, breathing, making music, trying to stay silent, you know, but everybody keeping my name in business.
Really?
But,
you know. Really?
Yeah.
He's the manager. Stop right.
You are.
Like, I'm share the manager. This like,
wait a minute.
The manager has arrived.
Yes, the manager is here.
Nah, I ain't the manager.
And you didn't tell us you was a manager nobody last time you was here when we talked.
I'm definitely
he was
not battling. Manager.
He was managing KT. The fuck going on
exactly.
Here?
Exactly.
Yeah, right. Yeah, I highly doubt that. Yeah, no.
How do you just get a label on you like that? They just say, oh, we're going to say Vonnie G is the manager.
Because of Marley. I love Lil Bro to death, but everything was talk to Vonnie. Like, man, I'm just an artist, and everybody don't need to talk to me.
Maybe because you're the boss of the group, maybe?
No. Nope.
Like, you wouldn't...
A good
who's
mediator
the boss of the
something?
Group, then?
Nobody.
Okay, well, I don't mean necessarily, like, the boss, like, in the group, but I mean, like, you may be the person that people will go to, like...
I would say me and KT. Me and
exactly.
KT keep it together, yeah.
So maybe Marley talked to you more than KT, then.
He does.
So that's why he said go to Leon. That's why he said go to Vonnie. Because you going to lead us in the right path.
I just want to make sure he's ready to battle. Like, I don't want to manage him. I just want to make sure he's ready to battle so he can throw up on stage.
So what are you going to do to make sure that he's ready to battle? Like, what?
You know, just make sure he's hydrated, not drinking, you know, saying make sure he's good, get some rest. Like any other artist, when you get ready to go on stage, you don't want to be dehydrated.
You don't want to be there like last time throwing up on people and shit. They almost threw up on Rum Nitty.
Right, pancreatitis is serious.
Oh,
so,
my
you know,
God.
So a lot of times when he get excited, that's when it flare up. So, the moment is like, yeah,
that nigga, that nigga need to calm down on lives because that nigga be getting heated.
Oh, I know. I talked to him right after them lives. I'll be like, bro, what are you doing?
Hey, but that live today was fucking classic with him and Phile. Oh my God. That nigga started lighting the stage. I forgot the fucking song he was singing. Oh my God. That shit was classic, though, nigga. I was literally laughing. Like, my stomach was hurting because I was laughing.
I just hope he's ready for the trial that Marley is finna, like, unleash on him. So I just really hope he's ready.
You hope Phile's ready?
Yeah, I hope he's ready.
Are you familiar with Phile?
Sort of, kind of. He was in my studio session one time with Banks. He came in. I met him for the first time. He was a pretty cool dude.
How'd you feel about his music?
He's dope. He got some nice lyrics. You know, I ain't going to hate on him. He's nice. You know, to each his own. They do his thing. So
that's the only thing. Is like, I don't know. Because I think Phile is like, as far as his music, he's very good. He gives you those J. Cole vibes. Mm-hmm. Like, that's the type of music that he makes. And it really is good music.
Yeah, you got something to talk about.
Yeah, he does. And he knows how to put his shit together. Actually, I'll take that back. I feel like he has great lyrics. But with me and Phile, the way I feel, what I feel that he lacks in is putting an actual song together. I feel like he would be the dopest fucking ghostwriter for somebody. I feel like somebody else could take his lyrics and go somewhere with them.
Yeah.
So I just feel like that's what Phile lacks in his music. Like, I don't feel like his vibe, the way he be delivery, I guess maybe his delivery of the song that he's doing is maybe that's what lacks for me as far as me personally listening to it. But when you just want to listen to lyrics, like, Phile got it. So that's when that battle comes.
It's gonna
that's
be a good
gonna
battle.
Be something.
I think it's gonna be a good battle for them, especially for Marley. You know.
Yeah, but we ain't here to talk about fucking Marley. We already said that he ain't the manager in a discussion.
Nope, I ain't the manager.
You're not the manager.
I let Val.
So what the fuck you got going on?
Oh, man, I got a single dropping at midnight tonight called "Smoking I Rise." So I'm pretty lit about that.
And no, it's just you by yourself.
Yeah, it's me and this up and coming artist out of Atlanta named Smokey Vintage. He is really dope. really lyrical.
Smokey Vintage. That's an interesting name.
Yes. He's got two projects out, The Bachelor 1, The Bachelor Chapter 1 and The Bachelor Chapter 2. Definitely dope dude. If you've never heard of him, definitely go listen to him. For real, for real. Mm. He is hot. For East Atlanta, this kid got bars. Really? He got bars. For real.
Okay.
For real. It's dope.
We're going to have to listen to it. So then you got a single dropping.
What was that name? Hold on. Let me write that down. I forget.
Vintage.
Smokey Vintage.
Okay. I was about to say Vintage Savage.
I don't think they can hear us. Anything. V-N-T-A-G-E. It's a turn up. They couldn't hear us.
Who can't hear us?
I don't know. Okay. So Smokey Vintage. Okay.
Yeah.
All right. So this is released. Are you going to have a video?
Yes. I'm actually going to Atlanta to shoot the video in a couple months. I'll be in Atlanta probably the second weekend of May. To shoot that video with him, so it's gonna be dope. So I'm gonna try to do some shows while I'm out there, get my name buzzing out in Atlanta and stuff like that. Cause
as you should,
right? I mean, the world of hip hop is bigger than just Arizona, and a lot of people get stuck running the hamster wheel here.
Yeah,
like, nah, fam, go outside of here and let everybody else hear you. If everybody know you here, okay, it's time to go outside of this.
Exactly, that's so true.
So who's going to shoot the video? Are you taking your videographer from here, or are you going to link up in...
Actually, KT's uncle in Atlanta is getting ready to shoot the video, and he's getting ready to do my photo shoot out there. So we got some like little family plugs on the low. So I'm actually excited, but I'm going to actually bring it back and let Dub edit it. So.
Oh, okay.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay. I trust Dub. Like.
Dub's your main guy?
That's my main man.
A-Dub. The main guy.
Straight up.
All right, that's what's up. And then you just had another release of a single with you and J Mello.
Facts. So lit. Yeah, I just shot that video, so I'm waiting on that video to come back from Dub. We basically reenacted House Party. So that's really? What we was really on. Yeah, we wanted to have fun. Instead of us doing the dances, I had my niece there. He had his daughter there. Mm-hmm. He was going to have them battle and do like TikTok dances, which was going to be lit. So
it's like an upbeat type of song. Yeah. Hear this song. So it's like upbeat. Like, okay.
Yeah, something you can turn up to in the club. You know what I'm saying? Chill with the ladies and all that. So it's cool.
That's what's up.
Got out of the trap music and the street music for a minute. Make some fun music.
Yeah.
I love trap music.
The summer is coming up. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, it's March, so now it's time to get into that summery, picnicky, mm-hmm. songy, yeah. birthday songy type stuff.
Yeah, I got tired of shooting people in my music. So I was like, I think I'll have fun.
Shit. Yeah, please.
Like, everybody always die in my music. Like,
That's like I was just telling DJ how I was just like, over the weekend, I was hiking, I was listening to some song. This music is so violent. Like, everybody verse on there was violent. I was like, oh, I can't do this. I need a break.
Yeah, I mean, after a while, as an artist, you get conscious of it. Because it's like, it starts saying the same thing over and over. Yeah. It's like, dude, I'm tired of this.
Like challenge yourself.
I want to have fun.
Yeah.
Like,
yeah.
Some artists, they just stuck in that lane. I'm like, nah, I can't.
It's boring, though. It's like, because it's going to, your audience is going to get dehydrated. They're tired. Right. Like, that's all they expect from them. They don't want to hear something else. So you got to surprise them and, like, put something else out your head. And like, oh, I'm coming this way because everybody used me going in this lane. I'm going to come with, like you said, like, a upbeat, like, you know, club song or something like that. Or we got to, like, do something for the ladies.
Yeah, that's what I said. I like making music for everybody now. So I make something for trap artists. I make something for ladies. I make something for the smokers, whatever.
Yeah.
I just like doing it all.
Get in all the areas.
Right. Touch every genre, forget
it. Exactly. Shit, that's what you gotta do. So let's get into one. Are you wanna get in this the song with you and the Vintage Smokey?
Yeah,
Vintage,
man, I want y'all to hear that. Yeah, definitely.
Or did
definitely.
You wanna do the one with J Mello first?
Nah, we're gonna do Smokey Vintage because, you know, we dropping that at midnight, man. Shout out to East Atlanta. You know how we get down.
And he's in Atlanta, he stays in Atlanta.
He stays in Atlanta, yeah.
Is he a known artist out there?
Up and coming.
Okay.
So he's building a lot of buzz right now because he's really authentic hip hop. You know, so he's not like the typical Atlanta artist.
Okay.
You know, kind of a mumble rapper. You know, nah, he's I'm gonna spit these bars.
Okay.
All right. Okay.
I need that explicit.
We're gonna see.
Hold on. Oh, I got it. Okay, let's play it.
I want to battle out with some AZ records.
That was my shit. That fucking Cat Williams.
Oh, that.
That was literally when I had first started fucking smoking.
Pimp Chronicles.
Bruh. When I first started, that's literally like when I first started smoking. Because I didn't start smoking until I was like 22, maybe. Yeah, I think I was like 22 when I first took a fucking blunt. Like, bruh. That motherfucker used to have me fucking rolling. I was on the fucking ground crying when I first seen that shit. And it wasn't. And then when I watch it when I'm not sober, I do not laugh like that.
No.
When I
was high.
Yeah. But that shit was funny as fuck when he was talking about that cereal with them kids in the cereal. I forgot
right,
the fucking.
Standing at the refrigerator.
Yeah. Bruh. That shit used to have me fucking weak. I haven't watched that shit in a minute. That's funny that she put that
and
on.
And that was
there.
Stand up, right?
That was his stand up thing when he was in that purple suit.
Yeah, that's when he got fucking, signed by Dipset.
And his fucking hair was like fucking straight perm. I didn't know he got signed by no fucking Dipset.
Yeah.
Really?
Yep, he was a comedian signed by Dipset.
I didn't know that.
Yeah.
So how do you make money off him, off his videos?
Off his videos, like his appearances, and then of course, you know, he was doing Wildin' Out.
Yeah, he sure was. I forgot about that.
You know, so Cameron was making some major cheese off of him, like for real.
Cat Williams is.
They didn't
give
him no money because that nigga done fell all the way off,
Yeah, he did.
It's a lot of politics and that stuff. We really don't know what be happening behind closed doors.
Just like politics here. Just like politics everywhere. No matter where
you
go, you
be looking at somebody like, oh, they fell off, but you don't even know like the extent to what they had to go through to get where they at, you know, like success, and then next thing you know, oh god, he don't have anything. Like, you don't know what happened behind closed door. You don't know who stole money for him, tricked him out of a contract. It's a lot of stuff that happened that we don't really get to see in the media, right. You know,
yeah, you got another business for sure.
Exactly. They just put the ugly stuff out there. Like, well, what happened? How did he get to this point? Like, show us how did he got how you get to that point. Speaking of movies and stuff, did y'all watch Coming to America too?
Yeah, you ain't seen it yet. Oh man, why
bruh,
you sigh like that?
I don't have time.
Why
don't
you
even
sigh like
time.
That? Like, why
I don't
you sigh
even
like
time
that? Like, wait,
movies.
Wait, I gotta see. Like, why she sigh like that? KJ really hit a high sigh. Like,
she didn't like it.
It's not that I didn't like it, but I just need you to watch it so me and you can talk about it. Did Bryce, you like it?
I liked it.
It was
what
cool.
It was for the generation.
Yeah, exactly. You know, a lot of people. You watched the first one too, right?
Yes.
Okay, good. Because I think a lot of people didn't see the first one and they're watching the second one and not understanding how big this is for the culture, like how all the amazing, you know, actors that was in there, that they're still alive. I thought that was super amazing.
Somebody said, how is the people at the barbershop still alive?
They was old men at in the first Coming to America.
Exactly.
Like 30 years later, they still there.
Exactly.
Same dead. Chairs.
Them well, you know that Eddie Murphy playing all those roles.
Nigga, that doesn't
him
matter.
Arsenio Hall, yeah.
They
yeah.
was fucking 100 years old then. Them niggas is dead.
Maybe he looked like 100.
They are dead. Them niggas is dead now.
Well, maybe
sorry.
They waited to, maybe they made it to
do they
like
look
106?
The same or do they look even older?
Well, yes. They made them look like older.
Everybody
damn.
Looked older.
Because
yeah,
of
Lord,
course they
I wish
older,
I could live that long.
But then when they put them the makeup on, it's like, oh, yeah, you really look
yeah,
old.
It's like
them niggas is already old.
Right.
Yeah.
They wasn't even like 40 years old. Them niggas is already like 65, 70. Like, them niggas look like, what, 120?
I'll
them niggas
up.
Still cutting hair?
Right, they still cutting hair.
They still up there talking?
They doing,
like,
they doing
watch
up to date,
niggas
up down
phase.
Niggas
ain't
know
about no 401k back
man,
then. That's
they doing
the problem.
It all. They doing
oh,
it all now.
OMG, I'm dead.
Yeah, you know, yeah, I mean, I think a lot of people had a lot of high expectations. And it's like, no sequels ever.
That fucking sucks when you have
movie.
High expectations and then it just don't meet the expectations.
I mean, for me...
The original's classic.
Yeah, the classic, yeah. It can't touch... The one that they put out, it can't touch the classic. And I'm gonna leave it at that. It's okay. Well, something I'll watch again, probably not. But I will definitely watch the first one over and over.
And every time I see it on, I don't even keep changing the channel. Like, Coming to America is like
watch
classic.
It.
That's my
I say one
is.
Thing about that movie. You would die laughing at the ending of that movie.
There were parts where I laughed.
The part two? I mean,
yeah,
the,
part two.
It's
oh, okay.
Parts where
part
I
two,
laughed, but I didn't.
And then I thought it was like.
I didn't chuckle.
I was
I'm
going to
smoke
and
watch
no, you're going
to
giggle.
Bam.
Exactly. You
if you smoke and watch it, you're definitely crying at the end.
You're going to giggle. You may add a little chuckle. No, just
I'm going to that joke and you go cry.
I'm going to say I'm going to watch it, but shit, I don't be having time to even watch TV. I got shows on my DVR backed up. I be trying to watch them.
It's short. It's only an
I mean,
hour.
You
like
blowing up now,
minutes.
So you got a tight schedule now, like the rest of
man,
us.
Man, you feel me? I'm like fucking. What the fuck? Like I'm out here. You know what I'm saying?
I'm out here.
I'm out here.
I'm out here.
You feel me?
DJ,
I'm out here. Everybody, out you know here. What I'm saying? Fucking messaging me and shit. That's something. I'm popular. Stop playing with me. No, I'm shucking. No.
Popping now.
But no, it's because yeah, if we be having so much, we be planning so much shit. I be having to do so much shit. Yeah, but it's really during the week. On the weekends, I be like nothing be happening at all.
That's how it is for me. Nothing happens during the week unless it's like.
For me, it's during the week. It's literally when I'm during the week while I'm fucking at work. But then after that, oh shit, what happened? Oh, but yeah, after that, like on the weekends, I'll be like sitting there like, fuck, I'm bored. But yeah, but these coming months, since shit is opening now, it's about to be lit. Are you about to be doing any performances out here?
Yep, I got a show on the 27th. Me, Denzel, and KT, we doing that that showcase with Drummer Boy.
Oh, I'll be there.
So we trying to do that. So we'll be there Then
okay, but just yawned. Okay.
We're doing the show for Val on the 17th.
April 17th?
Yep.
Where is it going to be?
At Block Studios.
Okay.
So it's kind of like the same
setup. I'm going to show up there.
Yeah.
She's doing it by her. Who's involved in this?
I'm not sure. I gotta still talk to her and get more details on it. You know,
is it her shit?
It's one of her shit. Yeah, it's her shit.
Okay, I'm gonna show up.
Yeah, it's definitely gonna be.
As long as it's not the other one there.
I mean, because we ain't performed in a while, so we are.
I think she told me about Yonteo's performing too.
Yeah, she got a whole bunch of people performing.
That's dope. Yeah, I'm gonna be there for sure.
I think CEO Yonte is headlining. I think.
Oh, he is.
Yeah, I think so.
That's my little brother right there.
He's headlining along with me and KT. Because me and KT.
And Denzel.
Denzel's going to be in California.
That motherfucker always in California at the long time.
No, actually, it's his son's birthday. My bad. I take that back. It's his son's birthday, so he's not going to be there.
And they going to California?
To shoot a video. I know he said he was shooting a video in Cali or something.
Yeah, this weekend. Like, he be in Cali.
That nigga stay in Cali with his old San Bernardino ass.
Yeah, he'll be in Dino shooting that video tomorrow. So, shout out to Denzel.
The IE. That's the IE.
Dino.
All right, so that's what's up. So, you could perform it on the 27th and you're performing on the 17th. And let me see, what else? No projects coming out?
No projects. I'm just dropping singles right now. You know what I'm saying? I don't want people to miss these gems, so.
Are you going to be putting them on an EP or are you just going to just drop it and that's just going to be by themselves?
I'm just going to drop and they're going to be by themselves. I have a lot of body of work. I mean, because we've been working since like the start of quarantine. We've never stopped. We've never had like a real break.
Right.
So like a lot of the songs that I want to put out is just like, okay, I'm going to put this out. They're all fillers just to see what people liking. Like, okay, y'all like this? Okay, cool. I'm going to make some more of that. You don't like that? Okay, I won't touch that no more. You know, so. And then after a while, then I'll put out an actual solo album again. But we do have our THM album getting ready to come out, so.
Oh, when is that dropping?
Probably within the next couple of months.
Ooh, that's going to be something. I need some exclusives off that.
We got you.
I need some exclusives.
I need some exclusives.
Yeah, that one's going to look, that's going to be interesting.
Yeah, I can't wait. That's been a long time coming, so.
Yeah. That's gonna be a good one because when y'all team up, y'all do be having some fire. That's facts. So yeah, I'm gonna be interested.
Are you guys
in
performing individually or as a group at?
On the 27th, we're actually performing as a group.
Okay. And then, oh, you are?
Yeah.
Okay.
Oh, wow. So that's why I said like a lot of people that we know performing. I was like, you know, you getting ready to go against all three of us.
Are y'all gonna practice? Are y'all gonna like show up?
No, we rehearse.
Are y'all taking away the background vocals?
Rehearse. Yeah, we book rehearsals. Like we do all that.
Good.
Like,
don't be out. Serious. Y'all gonna be long winded. Y'all gonna be out there.
Nah, like cause ain't no vocals. Like we strict no vocal artists. Okay. Like when we perform, so we actually do rehearsals. We have dancers that show up. They rehearse.
Like, and I know in a long time, right?
I haven't seen Denzel perform.
I don't think I've ever seen him perform.
I've seen Denzel perform. I just haven't seen him perform in a while.
Bro is lit.
I know he's lit.
You gotta check him out.
Denzel's lit.
I don't. Wait a minute.
Yeah, I think you've seen him perform before.
Was it at the awards? Did he perform at the awards show that time? No, he didn't.
When did Denzel perform?
The last time he performed out here was with
No,
us
I know him.
Arizona
his
Hip-Hop
music and stuff. Like, I'm tapped
that was
down
the last
him
time he performed in Arizona was with
was
us.
Was it Hip-Hop Festival?
Yeah.
I've seen him perform. I just know it hasn't been. I just know it hasn't been. A while, and I don't even think I see him perform last year at the Hip Hop Festival. I think I missed his damn performance.
Yeah, because we performed both nights. We performed both days. Like we both.
I missed his performance.
Yeah.
Literally, and I was wanting to go out there because you know I'd be working a thing. But yeah, I think I wanted to see it, and I think I had missed it by like one thing. Yeah.
Like a matter of seconds.
Shout out Denzel Davis.
About a matter of a whole performance. Shit.
He in the comments right now. Tell me some.
IE baby. Denzel, get out of here. Over here making up video shoots on Savage Night.
What other collaborations do you have?
I actually have a collaboration with Guz the Animal, which is a battle rapper, Arsenal the Rebel.
Oh.
So those are my two like major features that I have so far in the game. I'm working on something big right now with my management, so hopefully we can pull this off. And if we pull this off, that's going to be big for Arizona for real. And big for Milwaukee, so it's going to be dope.
We're just going to say Arizona.
I gotta put my city on too. You know what I'm saying?
No, but we made
no, you. No, you did when you came out here.
But we made you.
My thing is, Milwaukee made me. Arizona paid me. So, you know what I'm saying?
No, we made you.
Oh, man. I was popping in Milwaukee before I came out here.
Let me go find out.
That's not what I heard.
Let me go to ask the hello.
Let me go hit up Buford.
Do you? Okay.
Buford ain't been Milwaukee in forever.
I'm about to hit up Buford.
You don't know.
Right now.
Okay, you don't know. Okay, all right. Thank you. They said they don't know. They said who is it?
Hit up Buford. Let me hit up Buford. Hold on.
So, Arsenal, is that, you say he's a battle rapper, right? Yeah. Where's he from?
He's actually from Jersey.
I heard that name before, too.
Unless there's another one I heard of that Arsenal before.
I heard of him.
Arsenal Rebel. They, both of them actually battled Cassidy. So they actually battled Cassidy and beat
Maybe
Cassidy.
That's where I heard it from. Yeah. Was that recently, the Arsenal with recently?
That was like a couple years
ago.
That was a couple years ago.
I don't
know then.
Because it was like.
But I heard that Cassidy was about to battle someone recently, though.
I don't know. Whoever he battled, he probably going to get destroyed. Again.
I wonder what happened to Cassidy. Like, Cassidy used to, like, go.
Yeah, bars,
like,
yeah.
I don't know what happened to him. Like, it's just now.
Sometimes
just,
he gets losing, I guess. Shit, I don't fucking know. Or maybe he had a ghostwriter.
The game evolves, especially battle rap. It evolves all the time. So if
you watch battle rap?
Yeah, I'm an avid watcher of battle rap.
Who's
so.
Your favorite battle rapper?
Of all time? Murder Mook.
No, you can't come over here and say that.
Why?
Because he'd make me so mad. I can't. Ugh.
Oh, you not see the classic battles with him and Sirius Jones?
Yes, I do. I know that, but he fell off. And every time I see any promotion with him saying anything, I just scroll past. Like, get this trash off of your.
I mean,
booty.
But right now, for me, right now, it's K-Shine and DNA. Like, better than K-Shine and DNA.
Did you? Okay, so did you see K-Shine, DNA versus BT Gotti and Rum Nitty?
Yeah.
That was dope, huh? Yes, that shit went hard, huh? Who did you go for?
NWX.
Okay.
All right. I didn't see that.
Okay. It was, you gotta, that one right was so fire. Like, it was just so good. Like, I watched it, or I'm gonna go watch it again probably this weekend. Like, me and my sister, my brother, we'd be on the phone, like, we'd be watching this stuff because they are, like, heavily, they are battle rappers. Like, hey, they love that stuff.
Yeah, last time I saw them perform, like, live in a battle was in Milwaukee, because a lot of them come to Milwaukee and do battle rap. Because battle rap is big in Milwaukee.
Really?
Yeah. And trust me, it's serious there. Like, it's real bars, real camps, like, real beefs. Like, it's serious.
So it's the same as out here?
No, they don't do the trolling. That's one thing that's different in Milwaukee. They're not trolling. Like, they're not doing all that talking. Like, it's strictly rap. Like, if you want to rap. If you want to talk, don't go to the streets.
With no choking. Like, you know.
Ain't no choking. And I'm talking about venues packed out. Like, wall to wall, can't breathe. Smell.
And the stage is too, like, to be, like, super,
sometimes it's right there on the floor, like, whoa.
I need to go to Milwaukee then.
Yeah, it's lit.
I want you to watch that battle. I'm going to send it to you.
You did send it. I started watching it, and then I had something to do, you know what I'm saying? And I started watching it, and then
That's a real sport, though. Battle rap is a hell of a sport. I'm telling you, it's like watching basketball or something, but better, just with bars. And
nothing's better than basketball.
You get hyped. Please, man. This is, man.
Nothing's better. Sports come out.
Man, I'm telling you, this is a real life sport, man. Yeah.
I mean, that's why I said, like, I want to shout out, like, Goods and stuff like that, because when I first got a feature with him, he was the first artist to actually, like, give me his personal number and say, yo, if you need anything, reach out to me. I got you. And I was just like, damn, that's love right there, G. Like, ha. That's pretty cool. So, it's just the vibe you give, the energy you give off to people when you start to reach out to those industry folks to, like, get features. And, like, I was listening to y'all earlier when I was driving over here, and he was right. Like, a lot of people pay for features, and the artists don't repost, they don't share, they don't do none of that, and it's a waste of money.
Right.
And I tell people all the time, like, when you get a feature like that, like, get a contract or something, dude. Like,
for the promo. So I guess, I forgot who, I think Val was saying that artists don't negotiate that in their contract for the promo.
No, because they're so geeked to get the feature.
Mm-hmm.
Like, they're so amped up about the feature, and it's like, they forget about, all right, when
the actual
done,
benefits
do,
of them.
Right.
Because there's nothing for a mainstream artist to go ahead and do a feature. You can them. Like, that's nothing. They going to, I got paid to do that.
Right.
But, like, you have to think about the bigger picture. The bigger,
like,
picture.
Why are you getting this feature?
Exactly. Like, you want to eat off this. Like, you want people, you want to grab their fan base. You want them to know, like, hey, this is who I am, where I'm from. Like, I don't care about the feature. Yeah, that's good. But, yeah, do the extent and pay for the promo, too. And I think maybe a lot of artists don't know that.
Yeah.
That's another thing. You know, maybe they don't know that or how to.
I'm gonna need people not to be spending that much money, whatever they do on the features, and not know this information. Like, if you're spending anything with a big artist, that means you're obviously paying some big racks.
That's
I'm gonna need you to know what you're doing with this big racks. Like,
exactly. What you're getting yourself
into. Right.
A lot of artists, like, I tell people all the time, it takes 2 seconds. Like, when I did the song with Goods, with me and KT, like, it took him 2 seconds. He reposted it to his Instagram page.
Did he?
Just like that.
Who is Goods? I don't think I know who Goods is.
Yeah, he's a pretty dope. He's one of the top tier battle rappers you know, out in the game. But, you know, he's more so, you know, pushing his other endeavors right now with his cologne and all that stuff. He's just did a couple features with Davies. So I was like, oh, yeah.
Okay. Oh, Davies.
Yeah. Davies. I know him.
Duh. Like, know who him. Don't know Davies?
Just because I didn't know none of the battle rappers that y'all over here saying.
Yeah. He ain't no battle rapper, though.
I know he's not a battle rapper, but I'm saying, like, he finally said a name that I know. So.
Yeah. It's a lot. It's a, that's what I'm saying, like, battle rap and, like, that's just been an artist and rap. Everybody can't battle rap.
No.
Like, that's what I'm saying. It's a sport. Everybody ain't good at it. Like, it's either you got it or you don't. That's how I look at it. It's right. Nothing to be played with. And people think they could just jump in this lane. I just be like, no. Go back over there.
Right. Go back over there. Have several seats, sir.
Exactly. Like,
go over there, unk.
This ain't from you. You know right. what I'm
go
saying?
Go on over there, unk. You good, bro.
Like, it ain't too many people that play basketball that can go play football. You know, right. vice versa. So there, it's like.
It really ain't. So that part like, I know.
Exactly. You feel me? Like, it's like
football
it's
players make the worst basketball players. I swear.
Man, they do.
I don't like, see this with their shoulders. They like, hold you with their shoulders.
I'm like, are you a fucking athlete? Like, you like an athlete, but you're fucking not. Like, what are you doing?
That's why we say stay in your lane. Everything ain't for everybody. It's, like, very rare that you'll see someone that can play all type of different sports and actually mm-hmm. be successful.
Those are
good
true
at
athletes.
Those are right. true athletes.
Natural athletes.
Okay? Yes. They athletic. Athletic.
Deion Sanders, you feel me?
Man, you feel
Jason
me?
Jason Williams. White Man. Boy Jason Williams at that. That motherfucker cold.
White chocolate boy.
Yeah, that boy yeah. cold. So when you go into sports, that's when I start talking back in here. We got to talk about battle rap. I'd be like,
this ain't my lane.
Oh, no shit about battle rap.
Oh my gosh.
But yeah, that's what's up though. So, what else? Do you have any other interviews coming up? I know you've been interviewing Tough lately.
Yeah, I've been interviewing Tough lately. Right now, I got a break, so I'm happy. I got a break. I kind of focused on the music right now again, and then get you know pretty much dive back into this THM album and get back to work and so we can get this project out for everybody, so y'all can take a listen and let us know what y'all think. Because I think we're gonna do an album release party for this one. So
when?
When we get ready to release it in a couple months. So.
Oh, a couple months. Okay.
Don't worry. Like,
we're going to get everything worked out. We're going to do some live performances, have some people perform for us and all that stuff, too. So.
Oh, that fucking fine. But
it's annoying.
I know, annoying as fuck.
I feel like you're going to punch me in the face.
Let's wait, what?
Keep like, bobbing. Oh, like,
who brought that in here? Y'all know. You know how I feel about.
Them people that just came in.
Y'all know how I feel about stuff flying around. Like, nothing that crawl, nothing that fly.
That's the fly from Mike Pence head. You know, he's traveling, doing a tour.
I know how for real, huh?
Don't say that.
Right,
don't say that. Like, don't say that.
Don't say that.
Somebody right. play with a voodoo doll. I'll just play.
That's crazy. That's crazy.
What?
Voodoo dolls? Oh, no. That's that Creole stuff.
Exactly. Louisiana.
That Louisiana. That Baton Rouge.
Louisiana.
Man, that, have you been to Louisiana before?
Nope.
I mean, it's like, I've been there. My sister lives there actually now. She's been living there for like 10 years. But when you go there, it's just something in the air. Like, I don't know. Like, it's real. Like, how people, like, it have, like, this, I don't know, a spirit or something. I can't put my hands
on it. I just want to go for a crab boil.
The food is good. I ain't going to lie.
I want some rice.
Mardi Gras.
Beans or some. You know
I heard
saying,
Mardi Gras be popping though.
Yeah, but it's dangerous. It's dangerous.
Is it?
Yeah.
Because them niggas be drunk.
It's
as
dangerous
fuck.
In New Orleans. They are nothing to play with. Don't you go down there. Like, I be hearing stories like talking like the bar people be in on it. Like, especially if you're from out of town, like, don't travel like by yourself down there drinking and trying to party. Like, that's dangerous. They are not for no games. In New Orleans,
they ain't can't even go there.
Man.
Fuck.
I'ma just watch it from over. I ain't going, I'm good. And my sister been there for 10 years and ain't never been. She do not go to New Orleans. There's
so
nothing to
be
play
from
with.
There or what?
Not even, I don't, it's, they get down, man. There's nothing to play with. So if you go, you better go with somebody that's from there and you better try to like kind of be sober, like, cause no, it's.
That's what they said about
Mexico. I heard the people like really nice though.
Yeah.
They said like nice the people are really nice in like New Orleans, but they just. Really not for the bullshit.
People be coming up missing and found in ditches and like.
Are you serious? My friend went.
Sounds like the Midwest.
My best friend went to Louisiana and she went to college out there. She ain't say none of that shit.
Cause she probably wasn't out like that. Was she in New Orleans?
Yeah, she went when she was like 18, 19. Like, yeah. What you mean? She was it's definitely out like that. There. She was out there.
What school did she go
party.
To?
I don't fucking know.
Yeah, but yeah, I'm good. I'm cool on that.
I'm gonna ask her tomorrow. Shit.
I'm cool on that.
Well, that fucking sucks. You kind of like.
With the subs.
Right. Now I can't even fucking go over there.
Y'all can go if y'all
can't
own.
Look
I'm
forward
dying.
To go to fucking Mardi Gras because a bitch is gonna die out there. Like, what the fuck?
That's wild.
That's
crazy.
Right. I don't even
want to
go no more. Like,
right,
Kevin,
like
threw me all the way off. Like,
y'all don't even want to go stuff.
I'm good,
no, I'm just telling y'all. This is. I'm not making like if you're reading
Orleans,
this stuff.
Nah, I'm straight.
I don't even want to go to Mexico. We just talk about Mexico. I was in the fucking studio with Dub and Yante and them, and Dub was saying how he had just came from Mexico.
What part of Mexico or New Mexico?
don't know, the fucking Mexico where you gotta cross the border.
Okay, so that's real Mexico.
Yes, and he said how people be out there, like, he said, like, they'll be out there plotting on you. Like, they know, like, facts. They know when, like, the tourists come out there. Facts. So they'll, like, send people to come, like, check you. And then, so the police will come over there, then they'll be asking you for money. Otherwise, you're gonna go to jail. And I'd be like, damn, nigga, I ain't going to Mexico.
Stay in your own country. I mean, I'm cool. I like traveling and stuff, but trying to go to other countries, I mean, I love my life too much. You know what I'm saying? You just don't know what be happening in other countries. Like, you are a tourist. They prey on tourists. Like, for real. Like, they know you're out of town. Like, you're not from here. People don't like people from America. Like, they don't understand.
So I
like,
shouldn't go to Jamaica.
I'll be real with you. I don't, like, overseas, they don't like white Americans. They don't like, you know, black people. Y'all good, like, we good over there. Like, I've been overseas.
Well, some people done went to countries and didn't come back and they were black.
I know.
So,
I
mean, like, the minute.
And some people get abducted just to go over there.
Yeah. I mean, you gotta definitely watch how you move, but that's anywhere, though. I mean, because they definitely gotta watch how they move when they come over here. You know what I'm saying? Because it's the trenches, too.
In certain areas, yeah.
But I'm just going, I'm not going to Mexico. I'm gonna stay.
I always said I wasn't gonna go to Mexico, and he just confirmed why I'm not going to Mexico.
Oh, who confirmed?
I've already dubbed it. He confirmed, like, because I always said I'm not about to go to Mexico. Like, I'm not about to. And then, like, everyone was like, oh, you should go. It's fun.
Yes.
Then he just said all that. That's why I'm back on. Yeah, I'm good.
And like, no, I have friends from Mexico who, like, I drive there outside. I'm not, I just don't feel comfortable.
Yeah, because somebody, you know,
I might go to the,
you
know,
you gotta go in a group.
I might go in a restroom or something. They come out like, and I'm like, what? And my friend is, no, I'm good.
Yeah,
you see what happened with Taken. You know what I'm saying? So I love Taken. Because
if my son get Taken, that's what I'm about to be on. I'm about to be on some Taken bullshit.
You're gonna
I'm about to go find his ass.
Okay, that's how I'm coming with it.
Special set of skills. No, special set of skills.
For real, that's how I'm coming.
You gonna find out when that shit happens. I bet you that shit gonna come alive out of somewhere. I don't play with my kids. Stop.
Parents' intuition is real, though.
I just told you. Really is. I'm losing my life for mine. Don't play with mine, because I'm going all in.
Bitch in jail.
I'm going all in for mine. I'm not gonna wait on nobody to do anything. What happened? Oh, it's a whole go. That's all. I ain't second guessing. I ain't gonna be no. I'm gone. Ain't no wait and report nothing myself. No, I don't think so.
They'll probably have to put me in jail because
I'm going to jail for real.
Shit. Everybody,
I will make history.
Why you didn't stop her when you see the when you see the kid? I see
you play with
camera,
mine.
Bitch.
You
the
play with
everybody
mine.
Dying.
You oh, play yeah. with mine. I am gonna make history. We are going to war.
Oh,
like
yeah. Nobody will ever
man
me.
For real. Like nah, I'm not about to be crying. Making I ain't doing none of that. I'm out of here. I'm in the streets with it.
She
I'm in the streets with it.
She not even gonna cry.
Give me the big green bag. Give me that big old green bag.
So she on one.
Shoot, walkie-talkie. Different cell phones and everything. Earpiece is like, what? Hello?
I'm like, KJ? Hold up, one moment.
She got all lines of communication. It's
man,
on its own.
Shoot.
Hotel? Hold on.
Shoot.
Hotel?
Book the hotel. I'm like, I need a cab right now. Pulling up right into the address. It's the street address.
All right,
I
just
got.
Say your name is this when you go
exactly.
in there. Your name
exactly.
Is
okay, different identities, all that. Like, I'm mad.
All right, go now. Door open. Nah, but yeah, that's crazy, though.
It's scary, though.
Fuck them other countries. God damn it, sometimes. I do want to go to Jamaica, though. I'm supposed to go to Jamaica in May. Y'all want to know what happened?
What happened?
So I'm supposed to get my passport, right?
Mm-hmm.
So I put in a freaking thing, because you know you have to make an appointment to get your passport.
Right.
So I put in Okay, first, I could not find my birth certificate so I can get a passport. So I had to get a birth certificate. And I'm from New York, so I got to, you know what I'm saying, call the American people to get my birth certificate. They said that shit's going to be 4 to 6 weeks. I was like, well, fuck it. I ain't going to be able to go because I ain't going to be able to, you know, it's in May. This is like in fucking February. Mm-hmm. So then I was like, yeah, I ain't going to be able to go, but I already had ordered it. They didn't tell me when it was going to come until after I hit order. And then all of a sudden it came in like 2 weeks. I was like, oh, that's what's up. So then I went to go set the appointment up for the passport, and they got them shits all the way closed. So I had to wait till March 8th. March 8th come, why I forget to go to the fucking thing to get the passport.
Slap yourself. You ain't trying to go. So that's a sign. No, that's a sign. But that is a sign, though.
No,
that's a sign.
So then, that is not a sign. So then I went on there, and I could go on March 25th. So if I go on March 25th, as long as I go on that day to get it, then my passport will come in time. But it was the fact that, like, damn, how you miss it?
Make
and
sure
then my
you
friend,
go.
I am. My friend was like, Ashley, when's your appointment? But she asked me, like, on the 5th.
So I was like, anybody gonna remember? And then the 8th, that's when all that shit was happening with the fucking, you know what I'm saying? The whole, I don't even know what the fuck, one of these battles or some shit was happening. Everybody, this the whole March been, you feel me? The ain't nobody think about this fucking passport because all this Facebook shit.
This Facebook dropper got me busy as man, fuck right all now. Day.
Can't do work, about to get fired from your job. You feel kids me? Hungry and
kids
stuff.
Kids hungry. Carl E. I was on the phone with Bonnie. I'm like, Amaria, get out the fucking, get out the goddamn room. Shit, the fuck. You hear me on a goddamn phone? Like, nigga, damn. Can't even get on the phone with people. Can't even get the tea. Can't even get the tea because the kid's in the room. You know what I'm saying? Yeah.
Belle said she loved NOLA, her favorite place to visit. So if y'all want to go, y'all should just team up. She going to be y'all tourist or y'all tourist guy.
I can't go.
I ain't going.
So we already crossed off NOLA. We already been to New Orleans.
Mexico.
But
I'm going to Jamaica, so don't say shit.
I've been through the year.
Don't say shit about Jamaica because I'm going there.
I got a story too.
You liked it? My mom said she liked it.
I heard it's nice.
We got family out there. My sister, her dad is up from Jamaica, so anything go down.
Jamaicans don't play though.
If anything go down, we shame. Okay, baby.
Yeah. Keep some Jamaicans on your side because they don't play.
Oh, yeah. My uncle is, my stepdad is Jamaican. My uncle was Jamaican. My whole brother and side of family is Jamaican.
Oh, really?
They're going to be at Ashley Watch.
Right.
I've been trying to tell people.
They're like, hey, girl, come here, girl.
I got so many people that know me that will go to bat for me. Like, it's crazy. Jamaicans.
That's dope.
No,
you don't want to play with them.
Right, you don't want to play with no Haitians, yo.
Ooh, you don't want to. Yes.
I used to have a Haitian from next door, but I refuse to go to their house. So that's where I used to eat cats.
Wow.
I'm dead ass. When I lived in
you
New York.
You know about them. They crazy. They don't play.
Dead ass. When I lived in New York, like, they, Haitians, like, they always had a fucking backyard full of cats. Like, bruh, they used to eat them motherfuckers. The food that they cooked, it did not look like some normal food. On God. I'm dead ass. Like, I was
that's
like,
how you used to eat cats.
Yes. Like, that's what I used to, like, me and my cousin, like, we used to be like, yo, they are eating cats over there. Like, stop playing with us. Like, that shit, like, even when you go in the house, like, the food don't even smell good. Like, the food just, it smells like some odd shit that they're cooking. Like, what the fuck is you cooking?
That's nasty.
I'm dead ass serious. Like, I'm not even capping. I will never forget that. Like, our neighbor. Yeah, I would go there and play with their daughter, though. But when they say it's time for to eat,
gotta go.
And they always be like, what do you want to eat there? I'm like, nah, I'm good. I'm going to go back home. My grandma said, I cannot eat over here. My grandma said, I
got to go home. My mama said, I got to eat here.
Yeah, that's what
I'm saying. My mama don't know you like that. She'll trust your cooking. I can eat it right. I'm allergic to stuff.
Yes.
Right. My mama said, everything my mama said.
Then it was my grandmama's because that's how I live with my grandma. I was like, my granny said, I cannot eat over here. She said, I can only eat at home. So I can't eat over there unless it's packaged food. No, I didn't say packaged food, but yeah, fuck that. I wouldn't eat shit over there. Even the sauce looked nasty.
Oh,
they
damn.
Had like some red ass.
Can't even
sauce
get sauce right. Oh, ain't that a bitch?
They had like red ass sauce or some shit. I don't know. That shit was weird. Yeah, that shit was weird.
I gotta look into their food. I'm probably actually
I ain't
good.
Eating no Haitian food. I'm good.
So you straight on the Haitian food.
I'm straight on the Haitian food, but Jamaican food I'll eat. All Chinese day. Food I'll eat. I don't eat sushi. I don't fuck with sushi.
You don't eat sushi, right? No. The California rolls?
I don't eat none of that shit. I even tried it. Like, one time I went to California, like, this is a fucking DJ Al show. This is supposed to be about you. But I did try sushi. I had to take that shit back. That shit was nasty. Y'all like sushi?
I love sushi too.
You gotta know what to eat. You have
right.
to go
you
to a place.
To
don't
that's
be going to the grocery store.
That's what everybody's saying. Every people, time somebody give me something new that I'm
Las
supposed
Vegas
to
roll.
Eat.
Man, Las Vegas roll is
that
flat.
That shit was nasty.
That dragon roll is bomb.
Get a Las Vegas roll.
Las
I got
Vegas
the California roll. I got
fried.
The Las Vegas roll. I got it's the fried. One with the crab with the rice on it. They was like, well, since you like crab, you'll probably like this. That shit was nasty. Like cold food, like...
No, you gotta go to like, well, one place I like is in Chandler. It's called Kobe's. There is really, really good.
Yeah.
Is you gotta go to the real, like, don't go to the grocery store. You can't have that your first experience. Well, I'm gonna go try some sushi.
Grocery store.
In the grocery
sushi.
Store. Yeah, I'm gonna go to Fry's. And yeah, they sell sushi.
my friend told me to pick something up at the grocery store for him, and it was some sushi. And I was like, what? And I was like, you about to eat this? And then he was like, yeah, it's good. Get this. And then he had a certain kind. He gets it. Maybe he eat like sushi on a regular. I don't fucking know. I wasn't eating that shit.
Somebody told me that they had food, like, Food City, they had sushi. He was like, you should try it. I was like,
Yeah, not up in Food City, the fuck.
I'll get some guacamole.
I don't even buy groceries for them motherfuckers.
I'll get guacamole. They got some
Food City.
I don't either.
I ain't going to Food City, dog.
Shop at Food City. I mean, I know. They got some good guacamole, though. I actually picked some up.
We get the fajita mix up, bro.
Actually, did have good breakfast
actually,
burritos.
Actually, you know what they got at Food City? When them people be out there cooking that grill, that rotisserie chicken.
Yo. That's what you go to Food City for.
That's the only thing. They got good breakfast burritos, too, because they make them fresh.
I just go get my fajita mix from there. I'm like, that's the fajita mix place, bro.
Yeah, I don't grow. I like shop. I grocery shop.
But that roast chicken, they be having that sauce on the side with that roast chicken when they be out there grilling.
Slapping.
That shit be fire.
Let me find out they sell
my
sushi.
Fucking God. I'm not eating shit else from Food City.
If you go to Food City on the west side,
they got sushi?
Yes, on 91st and Thomas, there is sushi.
What is it like?
I don't even eat sushi.
steak and like beans on this.
This chick is reckless. Oh, that was so racist.
No, I'm just saying, like, how you gonna make sushi? I just want to know, is it real sushi?
Bro, that was racist. Like steak.
Why would
you
say, no, it's not real.
You said, carne asada with beans.
No, I'm not saying, I'm just saying, like, how hard is it real sushi? Or, you know,
it's obviously real sushi.
I don't know, I just asked.
She tried to do damage control. Right.
Well, you're like, that was racist. Oh my God, KJ said, you know, I don't want to do that because I already had a problem with somebody want to say something about, no. When y'all speaking up on certain things and saying, don't put my name in it. Keep my name out of it.
You said carne asada with beans in a fucking sushi roll. You can't get it more racist than that.
How's that racist? Oh my
God. It's not racist. We know you're not racist. It's a joke.
Like, they really took a page out of like Fry's book. Like they have like a whole little Asian setup right there, like next to where they do like all the like their normal Mexican
food. I wouldn't do it. I don't even eat that.
Okay, well that's not. I mean,
but it's still odd though, because it's like Food City.
But what is Food City? I mean, Food City.
Food City.
Food City is like a Mexican. Well, it's like a Mexican grocery store.
It's like Aldi's in the hood for black people.
No, it's not. It's a Mexican grocery store. Like, what the fuck is an Aldi's?
Oh, yeah. You ain't been in the Midwest yet. Y'all got to come to the Midwest.
No, I went to Minnesota and I went to the Mall.
It's like equivalent to Food City. Like, but it's like black people. And you got to put a quarter in to get your card. Like, it's crazy. Like, they charge you for your card.
But that's in Minnesota.
No, that's in the Midwest. It's all over the Midwest. Aldi's.
Oh, yeah, no. Food City out here is for the Mexicans.
Right.
But black people shop there too.
Who the fuck would shop there? There's nothing there to get for us.
The black people that date Hispanics, that's who shop there.
I guess so. Or who don't know how to cook.
Like, what the fuck? Like, I don't even go get bottled water out of Food City.
I'm not going to Food City for a goddamn thing.
At all.
Like, I don't even go there for juice.
Y'all go to Rancho Market?
No. For what? Well, I think people go to Rancho Market for like meat. Yeah, like for me, I don't
KJ
go there.
KJ get the good meat. She see.
I go to Sprouts. I go to Sprouts to get meat, and I go to like fries, and I get meat. But I'm definitely not going to Food City for nothing.
If I want to go to Food City, I don't know. People didn't like Food City.
I didn't say people didn't like Food City. I said I'm not going to Food City. They don't have no food there that I cook. Like, unless I want to make maybe. I don't know, Mexican feast. I don't know. But no, because they do have a lot of Mexican, like, you know what I'm saying, style food there. Like, it is majority of that.
And it's, like, affordable for people that... It's to me, it's like, I don't know. I just only go to Fry's.
I'll just go to Walmart. They match prices at Walmart. So they will match Food City's price for the real food. Like, I'm not going to Food City.
Yeah. That's the only grocery store that's right, open. And you have to feed your kids.
Walmart is always open.
No, that's the only store that's open right now. I'm just saying.
And I'll give you like some pack of noodles or something.
Let me get some of that
they
ramen.
Don't have good meat to me, and they don't have good fruit to me. But I'm not saying like it's not a good place. Cause some people because people that make Mexican food, like they would go there because that's the type of food that they have majority of. Like the brands that they probably need in order to make the flavors of the food that they cook is gonna be at Food City, like Goya and stuff like that. Like that's the type of brands that they make. Seriously, I'm not trying to say like niggas don't need to like don't go there. Like no, I'm just saying like that's the majority of the type of food that they cook. Right. Would be there. Like if you go to Walmart, you're probably not gonna find the good, maybe
authentic,
you know what I'm
like Mexican food and stuff like that. Like
you would find that Food City.
Exactly, that's true.
Yeah, that's what I'm trying to say. I'm not trying to say like all them. No, not like that. I'm just trying to say like you know, yeah.
Like bashes. To me, bashes is what I would. Bashes is a fucking bashes. Terrible store.
Bashes
they got
is
everything
overpriced.
Is fucking nasty,
I thought it was a low budget store.
It is a low budget store. I can't fucking. That's Bashes is out there in Apache Junction, and you know what type of people is in Apache Junction.
I ain't shopping at Bashes. I'll drive 30 miles to get to a Fry's. I ain't stopping at Bashes.
I will go to Fry's, Walmart.
Right past every Bashes.
I'll go Safeway. No. Safeway don't really got shit, but.
Is that Safeway?
I've been at Bashes one time. No. I don't even know what I went in there for. I don't think I was getting stuff from my friend. Like, I was picking up some tutu for her. I was like, this is.
Hey, you know,
stuff.
I used to go to Albertsons. Y'all used to go to Albertsons. Y'all know about Albertsons?
Yeah, I know about Albertsons. That's a bougie, overpriced store, like, bite.
Man, it really is. Overpriced like a motherfucker.
Like, everything is too expensive. You don't. If you go to Albertsons, you're only coming out with four things and you're going to spend over $200.
Facts.
It is too, like, I'm not going there. Like, no. I'm not going. Like, when I go to my sister's and Kelly, like, she lived on the street from Albertsons. I'm like, you know why? I'm going to go find a food for us or something. I'm not going there.
Walmart and Sprouts is my go-to, though. What's your go-to?
Fries.
Fries. Yeah, I like fries, too.
Fries. I love fries. I need to actually invest in some stocks in fries.
Fries
because
is my
I'd be there
backup.
Too much.
Fries
that's
is my
first
backup
choice.
My
Walmart
first choice
would be my
Walmart.
Backup. Walmart would be my backup.
I go to Walmart because they got everything that Fry's got for cheap.
I be feel like I be getting extra discounts at Fry's. I be putting in my, and then I get fuel points, so no, I'm going to Fry's.
Yeah, no, I go to
Walmart. Get a gas station, that's a wrap.
I go to Walmart, yeah, it is.
Y'all don't do Sam's Club or?
I really want to do Costco, but ain't anybody trying to pay for that membership. But after Tone was talking,
but you only pay one, don't you pay for like 1 year? You don't pay every month, I don't think. I think it's a membership, you just pay like once a year, right? Yeah, you can pay, it's like $60 or something.
I may want to get it with a stimmy then.
Stimmy.
Yeah.
You better get everything with a stimmy.
I was going to say, because I don't know if y'all know, but they got the muffins there. This is ridiculous, the type of shit that we're talking about right now, but whatever. Costco got the muffins, like them big old muffins. They got blueberry. They got this apple crumb.
For
they
real?
Got poppy seed. They got chocolate.
They bomb?
And they got banana nut. Oh, my God.
They
and
best
they,
muffins in the world.
They do, don't they?
Yeah,
for real?
And them shits is, like, big, yo. Like, they're you can huge. Have a half of one for the whole day. You be Gucci.
I get the chocolate chip ones.
I like the apple one, the apple crumb.
Yeah, that fly is gangster.
It is like a motherfucker. It won't stop fucking with us. I don't know where that motherfucking fly came from, but yeah. Back to this music shit.
Safeway, okay, cool. Safeway got some bomb cookies. I just want to put that out there. They cookies just like
they not better than fries though.
They probably not, but I like Safeway. We get them fresh. I don't shop there either.
No. Okay, let's
back
play
to music.
Song.
We done talked
real,
about all type of grocery stores and stuff. Y'all done made me be. I'm not even like that. Matter of fact, let me go spend some money in Food City. Let me go there. I'm gonna spend like $5.
I'll go there if they cooking that chicken for sure. That chicken is fire. All right, let's get into this. So lit. Cause we over here
forgetting that it was time.
I'm riding all black when I'm smashing the whip. Back to back champ cause I'm winning the ship. I'm changing my lane, now watch how I shift. Fast and furious, no Tokyo drift. This is a ride and I'm not a lift. The shit is a rap and I've been a gift. Drinking this Henny, I'm lit off the fifth. Smoking this gas, I keep me a zip. Smoking that curry, I'm lighting a piff. Open the pack and come get you a whiff. I'm living a dream, I made me a wish. I've been on top and they call me commish. My life is so lavish, I'm making a grip. I'm never gon' fall, I'm never gon' slip.
I'm so lit,
I be all on my shit. I be all on my shit.
I'm so lit.